getting ready for Denver and North Dakota. That's Danton Heinen on that pack rib line everybody's talking about. I know Bucci and Barry will be talking about that line. Fellas?
Yeah, Danton Heinen, simply put, is one of the best players in the country right now, Barry. He's lighting up. He's the engine for this team. He's the star that makes everyone better. And, of course, North Dakota has their big line with Besser, Schmaltz, and Kajula.
Well, I just hope they're better than the movie, the Pack movie, Pack Rim Pac-Man? Movie, Pack Rim movie that I saw. So this line
is awesome.
I haven't
seen it. Should.
it's not as good as I thought it was going to be. I think the line is going to be better than I thought it was going to be. I've seen these guys play three or four games now. Moore, fantastic. Gabriel.
Yep.
They got speed. They got good size. They got vision. They play a real smart game. They're very tough to hit. They control the puck very, very well. It's probably the best line I've seen, even with Quinnipiac and Boston College. It's probably the best line I've seen so far. North Dakota's not far away with that line they got. But I'll tell you this, the line that Denver's got is fantastic.
Denver's going to start with Levin, Gabe Levin. He's their third-line center who got
is that accepted. Our lawyer?
He got
is
accepted
that our lawyer,
Harvard Law School. He hasn't accepted yet. He's waiting. He's holding out for better.
Wow.
Staub and Roemig. They'll start. They're going against the big line of Schmaltz, Kajula, and Besser to start the game. Jim Montgomery likes to match lines.
Yep.
He's an interesting coach. Both these two teams both like to go. We're going to have a great, exciting up-and-down game.
And I love Jimmy Montgomery talks about every line has plays they use off draws. The second, third, and fourth lines even have plays they use off draws, as do the skilled guys up in the first and second line. So we should see some fancy stuff come off draws. Both these teams can fly. They're both physical. It should be an awesome game. Last time they played, you called it the best game that you've seen in a couple of years.
6-4 Denver win.
6-4 game. It's going to be up and down. There's going to be chances.
And Jim Montgomery
hopes it. It might be a 1-0 game,
yeah.
But there will be lots of chances. Both goalies are going to see a lot of rubber.
Of course, Quentin Shore, his brothers,
yep.
Nick and Drew.
Nick
plays for the Kings.
Yep.
Drew's in the AHL. They have a younger brother, Baker. They said he might be
He's
the best
better.
Of them all.
He's better. Yeah.
The other two didn't even get to a Frozen Four. Mom and Dad, David and Sarah, both law students out of Denver. They met their first date, a hockey game, a Denver Pios hockey.
A hockey
game.
Family right there.
Probably going to have four boys end up playing in Denver.
Playing a good chance of playing in the NHL. And again, these two teams are similar. They both play fast. You mentioned Jimmy Montgomery wants a wide open game. He feels that helps his team. North Dakota's been here so many times. They've cut some close so many times.
It's our third year in a row we've seen him at a Frozen Four.
Dave Hakstol left, went to Philly. He might be coach of the year in Philly if they make the playoffs. The new coach comes in, and he's got him maybe poised to go to a Frozen Four again. So that's a fantastic story also.
All right, Brad Berry takes over. This is a little bit been a little more personable than Dave was. We'll talk to people about their grades, their family and stuff. So
nice guy like me. Coach how I coached.
Yeah, different, all heart. Different dynamic.
Big heart.
Maybe it'll be a different result for the great fans up in North Dakota. We'll have the game, of course. The puck drop here leaves a little after 8:30.
All right. I have learned that you don't mess with Barry when it comes to not hockey, you can mess with them. When it comes to movies, Melrose, now he's got a lot of free time to go see movies. None of us have heard of it. Clearly, Bucci didn't know about it either. My man Bonzani over there says Pac Rim was, in fact, a movie.
We sure? We sure?
Some kind of monster movie or something. Haven't seen it, should rent it. All right, so listen, you don't get to a semifinal of a Frozen Four by being a one-line team. So tell me something else about these two clubs besides just the top line.
Yeah, you look at Denver, they've had a lot of success with some of their freshmen kind of emerging. Troy Terry's a player last week in the regional championship. I thought he was phenomenal. He did a great job of igniting the team when the Pac Rim line in the first game against BU was not really going on full speed. So they look for him to, I guess, insert a little bit of energy. You look at the Grant Arnold, the captain. He's a good leader on that team. But on the blue line, these guys can move the puck really well and get pucks to the net. Butcher on defense, he had two goals against BU in the regional championship. He's a dynamic player offensively from the blue line, but he also can move that first pass out of the zone, which is so vitally important. And Blake Hillman had a huge goal in the regional championship as well, driving the net, getting pucks to the net, and getting into the zone.
I love the way Hillman plays. I love the jam that he brings to the game. I love his vision when he comes up the ice. Blake Hillman is one of those guys that has just really ignited this Denver back line. When you lose Joey Lalegie, you've got to replace it with speed and skill. And I think Denver as a committee by defense has done that. But Hillman, along with guys like Tarik Hammond, who has also been dynamic, they have been really, really good. And Denver's been able to push the pace, push the puck up ice, and make some things happen. On the North Dakota side, Drake Kajula, like I said, I call him highlights or us. He has scored some goals in his career that have been unbelievable. He's feisty, too. He reminds me a lot of when T.J. Oshie played at North Dakota. His first 2 years, very feisty, very aggressive, sometimes a little undisciplined, and then after that, settled in and really became a tremendous hockey player. I think for North Dakota, one of the things that will get talked about a lot as this game goes on and should be recognized is their defense. Now, as the year's gone on, they made some alterations to their defense. They had some set pairs. Osmus and Stetcher have played together for most of the year. Keaton Thompson and Paul Ledoux played together a lot. That had Tucker Pullman on the third unit with either Shaw or Willannon. They moved some things around to get Pullman more ice time because he can blast rockets. And because of that, their defense has added that much more dynamic step because Pullman is a two-way guy.
Up front, Luke Johnson, watch him. He's the mortar for North Dakota.
Who wins the game?
It's a good question. You know, they're both playing so well right now.
I'm going to need a pick.
Denver, I think, wins this game.
I couldn't give you an
answer. Come on, Star,
they're playing so well.
I don't know. Like I said, I've seen all five of these games. They are so dead even. It's a momentum break kind of game.
Pretty sure you both had Boston College in that first game. You know how that turned out. We'll see you in the first intermission. Bucci and Barry have the call coming up next.
That's right.
Well, it's true. Feels so good to be together with you. It feels so good, good to be together with you.
Put more fun in your day with ice cream flavored coffees at Dunkin' Donuts. Go for delicious flavors like butter pecan, cookie dough, or new pistachio. Enjoy one today. America runs on Dunkin'.
Meet the new John Deere Gator XUV 590i, a vehicle so versatile, it owns anything outdoors that ends in ing, like hauling, exploring, off-roading, and, of course, braking. 32 horsepower, a 1,200-pound payload, and over 1,000 different ways to configure yours. Go Gator. Visit your John Deere dealer to experience the new Gator XUV 590i, starting at just $9,799.
The Ram Heavy Duty, with a 6.7-liter Cummins turbo-diesel engine, gets best-in-class towing and best-in-class torque. So what does that mean? It means it's also best in boating, best in blizzards, best on the clock and off, because the best never rest.
Now get up to $5,000 total cash allowance on 2016 Ram 2500 trucks.
Welcome to the 2016 NCAA Frozen Four, presented by Northwestern Mutual. We are live in Tampa, and North Dakota has taken the ice as they prepare for their rivalry Frozen Four game against the Denver Pioneers. Two traditional powers going head-to-head for a right to play in the national championship game. The winner of this game plays Quinnipiac for the NCAA National Championship. The game.
Here's Besser, finds Schmaltz, tips it in front.
That would be tic-tac-toe.
What a beautiful play.
From the point, scores.
2-on-1, Terry, good pass, backhand. They score as the round is on here in St. Paul.
Turner, Willis, slot, Johnson, scores.
Pullman throws it at the net, score. Pullman, Sanderson, tipped it in front.
Hillman moving in, he scores. Denver takes the lead.
Look out. This offense is primed and ready.
And the first part of the Frozen Four goes to North Dakota.
The Denver Pioneers headed to Tampa.
And we are down to three teams with a chance to win a national championship. Quinnipiac has eliminated Boston College. They await the winner of our game next, North Dakota and Denver. John Butchergoss and Barry Melrose with you here in Tampa. We are live on ESPN2. Thanks so much for tuning in. Barry, two traditional powers, and I'm sure their fan bases are saying, it's time to win one. And they have the guns to do it. North Dakota has two number one draft picks on their top line.
Boy, it's an unbelievable line. It's one of the best lines in college hockey, just like John said. They have everything, this line. They move the puck very well. They got speed. Kajula, he's slick. He's a competitor. He just competes. He's a leader of the team. He sticks his nose in. You got Smoltz. I got to say it. You're killing me, Smoltz. Great play right there. And then Besser is the big horse, the young star that's got that great release and that great shot.
Denver was 7-7-2, Barry, to begin their season. They then go 18-2-4. One reason why: they are powered by their best player, Danton Heinen, a Boston Bruins draft pick. He plays the wing on their number one line with Gambrell and Moore.
Yeah, the Pac Rim line, and that line is scary, literally, just like the Pacific Rim is scary. This line's got everything. Heinen's a big horse, got a great skating ability. You're right, Gambrell is the centerman. He's really slick. He's good on draws, real thinker of the game. And then you've got Moore. He's the young guy that is a real competitor, a lot like Kajula. They're really fun to watch. Two of the best lines in the world, no doubt about it.
Quinnipiac and Boston College bet for the first time ever in our first semifinal game. These guys meet for the 276th time. A different dynamic. Great fan bases. They're here in Tampa. And for the second time, Barry, they meet in the Frozen Four. This is a rivalry game with so much on the line.
Yeah, and different type teams than we saw in the previous round with BC and Quinnipiac. Much more wide open, a lot more high draft picks, a lot more skill. There should be a lot of chances to score, even though both these teams are very good defensively, John. They're so skilled and so fast that we should see some two-on-ones and three-on-twos.
Colin Staub, Gabe Levin, Emil Roenick will start for Denver. The big line will start for North Dakota. The winner plays for the national championship on Saturday, and the puck drops next.
By 2050, we'll need twice the food from the same acreage to feed the world. That's going to take serious innovation. I'm John, research agronomist at Cope. We're challenging ourselves to create more advanced fertilizers that deliver nutrients to our crops more efficiently while respecting our environment so farmers can apply less and grow more. We are Coke.
Welcome to Stouffer's Fit Kitchen, where world-class chefs meet top-notch nutritionists. Prime cuts of meat, 25 grams of protein, bold, flavorful sauces, and savory mouth-watering sides. It's the perfect balance of delicious and nutritious, making it just the right fit for you. Stouffer's Fit Kitchen Meals. This is fit.
John Butchergrass, Barry Melrose, live in Tampa, Florida for semifinal game number two of the Frozen Four in Tampa. Barry, now time for our Capital One Impact players, and you're going with two smallest defensemen.
Big of heart, though, John. These guys got more guts than anyone else on the ice. They'll stick their nose in. They'll join the rush. They both got a ton of points. They can score goals. They'll be in the point in all offensive situations. They'll play against the other team's best player. Yeah, they're very similar, but I can guarantee you each team that they're on, they love him more than they love the other guy. They'll hate the little guy on the opposition lineup tonight.
They are a lot of fun to watch. Brad Berry coaches North Dakota his first year. The head coach of the Denver Pioneers, that man, Jim Montgomery, in the locker room moments ago.
Listen, this journey we've been on this year has prepared us for this moment. We have overcome obstacles, and we have done nothing but get better and better. Stay in the moment, no regrets. Let's go.
Yeah, baby.
Quinn Kesnick is between the benches. Hello, Quinn.
Yeah, that Denver Pioneer circle around goalie Tanner Gillette had a hold-your-breath moment this morning in skate around, doing a little two-on-one drills. Will Butcher comes in and stings Gillette with a wrister. right off the ribs. He goes down to the ice. He's down for over about a minute. Everybody's holding their breath. Gillette's known as a tough guy, but these goalies are a little vulnerable on the collarbone and the rib area. He skates it off, and watching him in warmups tonight, no worse for wear. But on the biggest day of your season, your goalie goes down. Had to be a tenuous moment for the Denver Pioneers.
Not a big goalie, Barry, just 5'11", 175, the sophomore from Red Deer, Alberta. And that's a scary situation we'll have to keep an eye on.
Yeah, very much so. It's hard enough playing this game when you're completely healthy, much less banged up a little bit. We had a chance to meet this kid.
He's fun.
Him. He's funny. He's got a great personality. He's always got a smile on his face. And his numbers aren't bad either, John. 1.67 yeah. goals against, 9.34 save percentage. Those are winner's numbers.
He's a Mike Richter finalist. Barry and I will give out the Mike Richter Award tomorrow night here in Tampa. We're underway. This should be a beauty. North Dakota and Denver. The big line of North Dakota out there to start against the third line, Romig, Levin, and Staub. Whistle early going. Puck went out of play. And the faceoff comes outside the Denver Pioneer zone. Denver again began the year 7-7-2, but they've been red hot since New Year's. North Dakota always brings a great fan base, and they are the loudest so far, Barry, of the four teams.
And the most sunburned. They've been coming down for some bad weather.
Well, they haven't seen it since October.
They've been out for like two straight days. They're getting sunshine. They're looking great. They're red. They know it'll turn when they go back to North Dakota. They just want to go back with the Frozen Four championship.
Quick line change for Brad Barry after that short shift. Wants to get Rhett Gardner, Luke Johnson, Austin Pognanski, the heavy line out there. And here comes the big line of Denver. Dylan Gambrell behind the net. Trevor Moore, California native. Called the Pac Rim line. They're all from the West Coast. British Columbia, Washington State, and California. Tarik Hammond goes back together. He's been a very impressive sophomore defenseman from Calgary. Here comes North Dakota again. Gillette looks fine there. That left side, or that right side, that he took the shot from Will Butcher, we'll keep an eye on.
More goalies get hurt in warm-ups than any time during the game. I don't know why people lose their brains in warm-ups.
Brock Besser, the big line's right back out there for North Dakota. Besser. First-round pick of the Canucks. Schmaltz, first-round pick of the Chicago Blackhawks. Some cycling action here. Schmaltz throws it towards the net. Kajula. Undrafted from Whitby, Ontario. Trying to prove himself for the next level. Here comes Troy Terry, number 19. Terry walks in. Terry back in wide of Johnson. Troy Terry, a freshman, slick player, Anaheim draft pick.
Kajula's a lot like Marty San Luis. Marty San Luis in town right now. I saw him yesterday.
Saw him last night, too.
He had to prove everybody wrong. Nobody gave him a chance to play. He was undrafted. Mm-hmm. He got cut by the Calgary Flames, believe it or not, and he turned into one of the best hockey players in the world. So Kajula's going to have to do the same thing. Little guys always have to prove they can play. Big guys have to prove they can't play.
Yeah, Marty, Canadian-born, played college hockey,
in
undrafted.
Vermont,
and now he'll end up in the Hall of Fame.
Almost won a national championship with Vermont.
Matt Van Voorhis. Shot comes in, a nice hard hit behind there. There's your boy, Grant Arnold, the captain of this team.
Love
shot,
that.
Block, rebound. Oh, Marston, who almost had a chance. The fourth line out there. Arnold gets it behind the net. Lost 18 pounds in the offseason. He's the leader. Jim Montgomery's pretty much given him the room. He leads this team by example and with his mouth.
And this is his time of year, let's face it.
This is when he shines.
This is when he shines.
Last year in the Providence Regional, Barry and I were there, and he had no goals yet. And Barry, like, what's up if you don't score? We kind of gave him a hard time. He scored and pointed to us up in the booth. And here he is here.
Didn't he get two goals that game?
He did. Red hot. So here the Pioneers. Heinen in front of Butcher, pinching the defense and across the Gambrell. The pass was a bit in his feet, and he was unable to tuck it in. Denver with a golden opportunity.
Yeah, great puck movement. You see the speed of Denver. If any, was very few teams can. Denver's one of them. Great puck movement. Puck going side to side right here. Good defensive work by North Dakota.
Oh.
I think it hit a skate, though, John. It wasn't like it was a bad pass.
Right.
I think it just caught. Yeah, right there.
Osmus was there, too.
Osmus was there. Bodies. Yep. Yeah, it was in his skates. He never got a chance to put a stick on it. Right there, you're hoping it just hits your foot and goes in because you really can't do much about it.
Gerstich, Simonson, and Olsen are out there for North Dakota. Some grinding fourth line action for them. Staub, Levin, Romig are back out there for Denver. One shot for Denver, none yet for North Dakota. Way behind Cam Johnson. The heavy line they call Luke Johnson, Rhett Gardner, Austin Pognanski.
Because they're a little chunky, they're all around 200 pounds. I think the average weight's about 2'5". In case you're wondering why they were the heavy line.
Here come the Pioneers. Gambrell shot. Shoulder save by Johnson. It goes up into the netting. So Denver flying down the wing there. Dylan Gambrell, the freshman from Bonnie Lake, Washington, draft eligible, almost made it 1-0.
Yeah, I think you see why the pack rim line is so dangerous. Let's see where Johnson is. He goes down Boink. Right off the coconut.
Stoink.
But again, those tall goaltenders, they get in their knee. They give you the top of the net if you can hit it. Right there, you hit the mask instead of putting it up under the bar. So he'll be aware of that next chance he gets, that the goaltender goes down real quick right there. And he's got to make sure he puts it up under the bar instead of hitting him in the face mask.
Quentin Shore, Evan Jansen, Troy Terry out there for Denver. There's Terry. Right-handed shot will go around. And out of the right side, throws it in front off a couple skates. And back comes Kajula. Kajula to Besser. Here comes Besser. Here comes the freshman. Force wide. Sheds a skater. Rebound in front. It's a juicy one. Doesn't go, though. Shore will dump it.
Well, right there, you got a good look at why Besser is very well thought of in the hockey world. Just a bull, takes it to the net. Great defensive play, knocks the puck off the stick. But I love the fact that he was going to the net with it.
For the first game of the year for many of these North Dakota skaters. Kajula has some ice. Has Schmaltz. Schmaltz turns, waits, turns again. Those that across the skate will come out of the zone.
They do the same thing as the Chicago Blackhawks in the offensive zone. The deactivate, which means they leave the defensive position and actually go down and take a forward position. You change positions with the forward. Chicago does it better than anyone else in the NHL, and you can see that North Dakota does it here in college hockey. Very tough to cover D that activates.
Colton Sanderson, Joel Janatwinen, and Brent Chizik out there. And a mad flurry in front of Tanner Gillette, and just stayed out of the net.
Well, there's the coming in from the side. I love the fact that he was taking the net. He was trying to do that. Good defensive work. Little bit of bad luck right there.
Boy, Butcher saved the day.
By Schmaltz. I told you Butcher's going to have a big game. It hops over Schmaltz's stick right there. And then Butcher comes in and knocks it out of there also. So a couple guys had a good chance to shoot the puck into the net. Good defensive help by the teammates.
So Will Butcher, the talented Colorado Avalanche draft pick from Sun Prairie, Wisconsin, World Junior, couple appearances. Really good defenseman. Great head for the game and really good skill.
Great skater. He just flies out there.
Paul Ledoux, LA King draft pick. North Dakota brings it back in. Playing behind the net. Gardner, Johnson, Pugnansky out there now for North Dakota.
Doesn't it seem like there's one less man on the ice compared to the previous game? There's so much room in this game. The passes are clicking. They're on the tape. There's nothing wrong with Boston College and Quinnipiac. Right. It's just a different style of play.
Clay Kilman. There with Butcher. Gambrell. Tries to get in deep. As Heinen. Six skaters for a few extra seconds.
Yep.
And then there's another change for Heinen. Here comes Nolan Zajac. You've heard the name Zajac a few times
many
over
times,
the years.
Many times. Yep. NHL hockey too.
Yep. Aiden Shaw. Up the boards it goes. It comes out. Terry. Troy Terry. It's onside. Puck goes deep. Quentin Shore goes after it. Back to the point. Oh, Zajac can't handle it. He had some room to shoot.
He was thinking right off the bat, what am I going to do with it? I'm going to shoot it right away. Didn't quite grab a control of it until then.
Simonson. Cross ice. Kajula's out there now. Butcher.
Playing that line a lot. Seems like they're double shifting that Kajula line.
Here comes Grant Arnold. He'll just get it deep and go get it. Bang bodies. Stetcher gets hit. There's Besser. Drops it back. Nice play. Here comes Schmaltz. Nick Schmaltz. Stetcher. He loves to get in deep and sniff one. Two's a lot of fun to watch in white and green. Besser can't quite keep it in. And Troy Stetcher. Richmond, British Columbia. Undrafted.
And again, when Schmaltz holds up like that on the line, he's waiting for Stetcher to come across that line. He just throws it directly across that line. Stetcher can walk in and have a great shot. So the guy's coming back for North Dakota. Got to pick that guy up. Or Denver, got to pick that guy up. You can't get beat up the ice by Stetcher. He's going to have goal-scoring chances all night long the way Schmaltz can skate.
Arsenal wins the faceoff against Gardner. North Dakota has it back again. Play is called offside. North Dakota still officially looking for their first shot on goal. No score.
The NCAA Frozen Four is presented by Northwestern Mutual. We help you live life differently. And in part by Domino's. Order online at dominoes.com.
It seems like every financial company talks about investing your way to wealth. But what about protecting what you're building right now? At Northwestern Mutual, we know the importance of doing both. We combine personalized investment solutions that help grow your wealth with world-class insurance that protects what matters most to you. This whole picture approach is just one of the reasons 96% of our clients stay with us year after year. At Northwestern Mutual, we help you live life differently.
We'll go to great lengths to get you hot pizza. Introducing the 2016 Domino's DXP with a built-in warming oven. Order our $5.99 deal and learn more about the DXP at dominoes.com.
Jack Eichel and BU strikes first. Eichel, one-timer, score! A.J. Greer! Eichel, will he win it? Yes!
For the second straight year, North Dakota goes home in the semifinal game. So, Barry, the last 2 years, we've called North Dakota in the Frozen Four, the heartbreaking loss, the final seconds against the Gophers in Philadelphia.
Awesome hockey game, wow.
Last year against Boston University, Brad Barry, the new head coach.
Ooh, I like the tie.
Assistant coach mentality.
You didn't find that tie the first store you walked into, I can guarantee you that.
He likes to communicate. Of course, the son of a farmer. Earl and Helga are watching back in Basha, Alberta.
Basha, Alberta, cowboy town.
Hello, Earl. Hello,
close
Helga.
Close to Pinoca.
Brad said he hated picking rocks and roots as a young kid. That was a chore.
Every farmer hates that.
But he's done a great job in year one, trying to talk to the kids more about, you know, their families and school and bring some of that to the North Dakota program. Maybe it might loosen them up this time of year. Maybe it was their reason they couldn't quite go all the way and win that final game. It's so hard when you get here. Everybody's good, but Brad Barry trying something different.
I think the stars are lined up for North Dakota. Dave Hackstall leaves, never won, goes to Philly. He's done an unbelievable job there. If the Flyers make the playoffs, I think he's probably one of the finalists for Coach of the Year.
Yep.
Brad Barry comes in to a team with 11 freshmen, and they've been awesome all year long. Maybe this is their year. You know, they've been close for so many years, so much talent. This might be the year that they get the job done.
Play behind Cam Johnson. No score here. Quinnipiac wins game one. They await the winner of this. Certainly their coaches are watching this game now, taking their notes. They get a head start on the scouting process when you do win that first game as the number one overall seed.
And they get to keep the big room. They get to keep the lightning room.
They get the big lightning room as the number one seed. Northwest Mutual planning for success, Barry. Let's look at how both these teams are planning for success, brought to you by Northwestern Mutual.
Well, Denver talks about they work on plays off faceoff, so this is the time to use it against North Dakota. Grant Arnold, lean and mean, we're talking about him, the leader of the team. This is his time of year. North Dakota, new coach, new mindset. Let's get the job done. Cam Johnson playing big. We love this guy. He's a fun guy to watch. Hopefully, he'll have a great game.
Looks like Colton Sanderson's in the box, Barry, as you can see here, trying to get that puck. First the stick, battles, and...
If the stick comes across, you know, parallel to the ice, that's one of the indicators that it's hooking.
We have a Hockey East crew. Jamie Koharski, Cameron Voss are the referees.
But as long as the referees have that the rest of the game, then Coach doesn't have a problem with that. If you set the standards for what a hook is early in the first period, then call it the rest of the game, there's no problem.
The lineies are Tommy George and Devin Begranek. So again, a Hockey East crew for this ball game between Denver and North Dakota. Power play for the Pios. Troy Terry, number 19, out there. Now Denver set up. Here's Butcher trying to find a shooting lane. Heinen, he's the dangerous player. Wrist shot just misses the top corner.
Johnson never saw that puck till it was by him. That went through legs and arms. That had a great chance of scoring if it was on the net.
Poked away from Gambrell. Quick change by North Dakota, but here comes some space for Heinen. Terry, what a beautiful move. but broken up. Here comes Schmaltz. Schmaltz, 1-on-1.
Wrist shot.
Glove by Gillette. Probably would have gone over the net, but still a good snare just in case by Gillette.
Saw a couple good wrist shots. You saw one right there by Schmaltz at the other end of the rink. Heinen showed way he can put the puck in the net for a bullet shot. Great job right there. There's a turnover. You see the speed of North Dakota. I like the fact he's challenging. Good quick shot through traffic. Might, yeah. You don't go through a leg, hit a leg, bounce the wrong way, catch goaltender by surprise. I just like the attack mode of North Dakota when you're killing penalties. A lot like Winnipeg.
First shot on goal for North Dakota. So Denver's done a good job.
Very good
controlling
job.
The play early on here.
But yet it seems like North Dakota's had the puck a lot,
yeah,
and they're moving it.
Yep.
And they're just not being able to get the puck to the net.
Right. So here goes Denver now. More than halfway through the power play. Blake Hillman, the freshman. Is it?
That's that hesitation entry everyone's using now in all types of hockey all over the world.
Pay attention, folks. Right in the noggin, it got a fan down. Again, Denver began the year, Barry, 7-7-2, 18-2-4 since New Year's.
Wow.
And they've just done everything better.
18-2-4 is fantastic. You're playing tough competition. You're playing teams like North Dakota. Your goals a game are up. Your goals against are down. Your power play goes up almost 8%. Pretty fabulous numbers. That's how you only lose two games. And the team that's going to play tomorrow night had lost three games this year. So pretty fantastic numbers.
Gambrell, Heinen, Moore out there with Zajac and Butcher on the point.
That's a good group. That's five good players, man.
So if they can win the faceoff here, get
win the draw, yep.
Maybe threaten to get the goals, the first goal of the game.
And Jimmy Montgomery talks. They have plays set up.
I mentioned the fan got hit in the head. He's leaking a little bit. He's walking. He seems okay, but he's going to get stitched up. Maybe North Dakota fan.
Leaking a bit.
Yeah,
okay,
just,
but
wow.
You put 2 seconds on the penalty clock and only 1 second up on the game clock.
I'd hate for you to diagnose me, John. Leaking a bit.
Yeah, there was some blood on that.
There's some blood on that handkerchief.
Got to pay attention.
Pay attention,
there,
John.
Get off your phones. Watch the game.
Sit behind the nets, baby. That's why the nets are there.
Butcher. Ooh, gets bumped off the plate nicely by Rhett Gardner. And it comes outside the zone. North Dakota doing a good job killing off this penalty.
Good!
Here they come. Heinen, Gambrell, Moore, looking to spread out a bit here and get going. Trying to fish it out. Here they go. They'll have one more chance. Looks like what a play by Heinen to Butcher. Zajac. Zajac looking back to Butcher. Walking in. Goes it across. Ooh! One time tip attempt by Gambrell. It goes just wide. Heinen whiffs on that pass, but Denver keeps it in. Heinen, that's going to come outside the zone. And the penalty has been killed.
Butcher couldn't stay in there. It was too dangerous. That's a play that looked like a shorthanded goal in the making, so he got out of there.
Moore spins away. Throws it across in front. Puck goes up in the air. Bouncing around. Marcinou. Wrist shot goes over the net.
People say, well, why do you shoot high all the time? Why are there so many pucks missing that high? Because that's where you have to shoot on these goaltenders, these big butterfly goaltenders.
Heinen goes to Arnold. Arnold walks in. Throws in front. Johnson covers up. Is it in? Loose, and it comes out. Here comes North Dakota. 2-on-1. Caggiula and Besser. Besser. Besser save Gillette. Back comes Denver. Here we go, Barry.
This is what we paid for, Johnny.
Round and up they go. Lucas Savage's battles behind it. Arnold, the fourth line out there. And that's the kind of up and down action we're going to see. Caggiula. Turns away. Manages the puck, doesn't turn it over. North Dakota.
No.
As Besser had a chance on a 2-on-1 with Caggiula.
No.
Blake Hillman out there with Van Voorhis.
And the big boys got all those chances. The top line guys got all those offensive chances. Great sequence of plays right there. Both ends of the ring. Great saves by both goaltenders.
Simonson, Olsen, Gersich out there. North Dakota looking for some sustained pressure. They haven't really had it. Only 5 shots on goal in this game. 3 for Denver, 2 for North Dakota.
That's unbelievable.
They've been up
with
and down.
Talent level this team.
They've been up and down.
It could be 3-2 right now to score easily.
Hillman. Denver tries to exit the zone. They do, but thrown right back in again there by Tucker Pullman, the Winnipeg Jet draft pick from East Grand Forks, Minnesota. Hillman. D to D. Adam there to Van Voorhis again behind the net. Denver will try to pressure again. Two on the puck. Battling Coleman there. And the puck comes out. Butcher goes back to get it. He's out there. Colin Staub. Now both teams kind of struggling to get the puck up and make consistent plays and get towards the other team's net. Stetcher. Self-pass attempt there by Johnson. Back the other way. Pognanski backhand. Nice blocker save by Gillette as Austin Pognanski, the Blues draft pick, had a backhand chance. Ledoux, number six, Paul Ledoux. Off the boards and offside at the line. Cam Johnson, some nervous moments early on. Oh, the right blocker hand keeps it out. And then a two-on-one. Besser looking to make a play. They gave him the shot. He took it.
She beams. She glows. Colorful mystery and adventure. She's a guide. She's a route. A story and a song. She is this day. She is this moment. She is this place. And she belongs to you. Only in Minnesota.
Add some spring to your space and find fresh deals on name brand furniture, appliances, electronics, computers, and more at Home Choice. Put a new spin on laundry day with the LG washer and electric dryer pair for less than $110 a month. Or sleep soundly in the SoundSleep platform bed that features Bluetooth speakers, LED reading lights, cup holders, and built-in storage for only $999.95. So come in and discover all of our spring savings at Home Choice. Tougher ends for your home, better credit for your life.
Starts here.
John Butchergoss, Barry Melrose back with you. 1993, the Maine Black Bears championship game against Lake Superior State. Only one loss on the season, down 4-2 after two, but in the third, Jim Montgomery gets a natural hat trick, all assisted by Paul Kariya. Cha-cha-cha, and the Bears win it all. Quinn Kestnick is with the coach now.
Coach Montgomery, how do you best describe the tempo and pacing we've seen thus far?
Well, I like the tempo we've been playing with. I think North Dakota here in the last couple of minutes up their forecheck, and we got to move pucks a little bit quicker. But overall, I'm happy with our puck possession time.
This is the sixth time you've played them. In the first 10 minutes, what's caught your attention?
Well, just both teams are trying to go north really quick and trying to attack each other's net.
Thank you, Coach.
He's a great player. Got into coaching when his professional career was over. Played about 120 NHL games. Went to the USHL, GM and coach, won two championships there at the USHL. Now he's come here to Denver, succeeded George Gwozdecki, and has done a great job to bring this team back to the forefront. I think he's a guy, Barry, we could see in the NHL as a head coach.
Very smart. I love the fact that he's innovative. He tries stuff off of draws. The players are thinkers. He tries to get them to do that. He doesn't want a bunch of robots on his team. He wants guys to go out there and be creative. He loves it when his team does that. The guys have fun. You can tell that when you meet with them. And, you know, he's a real up-and-coming, one of those great young coaches that are in college hockey right now.
Both teams now trying to figure each other out. It's you play a team this much.
Yeah, you play each other five times, you know. But there's so many weapons out there. You control one set of weapons, another group appears.
Fourth line grinding here for Denver, doing a good job keeping the puck in the North Dakota end. Bang body, penalty coming up. Power play, Denver on the way. Butcher will reset now with Gillette on the bench. Extra attacker on. Got to be careful here.
I've seen those go in.
Here comes Heinen. To Marson to walk it in, but Johnson will cover that up. And play will stop, and the Pioneers, that power play that was 4-for-8 in the regionals with 10 shots that really helped them get here, will have another chance on the power play. First time they had no shots on the first power play in this game.
Well, in college hockey, as in most hockey played, anything near the boards, anything from behind is going to be called. And that certainly was very, very quickly by the referees. So, as you mentioned, Denver's got another shot at getting that good power play of theirs going here against North Dakota.
So Denver with the power play. Rhett Gardner, part of that heavy line.
And that
Luke
heavy line's supposed to be physical. Yep. So, you know, he's going out there banging and stuff. But you're right there near the boards from behind. You got to be very, very touchy with that hit.
Johnson, Pagansky, and Gardner. They'll take the body and occasionally get a penalty. So now Denver, can they capitalize with their power play and get the first goal of this game that right now is in pretty tight checking and pretty tough sledding for these offensive players? Here comes Gambrell. Dishes to Terry. Terry. Back to Butcher at the point. Butcher, wrist shot blocked. Deflected in the corner. Terry will get to it. Cycle back down low. Now back to the point to Butcher. Here comes Terry walking in. Throws it across. Moore. 360 backhander towards Heinen's stick for the tip. And Johnson's there to cover it up.
That's how they drew it up. Everything was where they wanted it. The pucks were zipping around. It was going high, low, went across, and it just hopped over the stick right here. Everything was where they wanted it, went across. Their goalie's got to come across. And just as the shot's going to be taken by Gambrell, it hopped over his stick. So as a coach, I did everything I wanted. The players did what I wanted. We got the person... That's one of our best goal scorers in a wide open position with the puck. It just hopped over his stick. Can't really be angry about that.
Quentin Shore, the senior, taking the faceoff. North Dakota will be able to skate it out. Besser out there killing the penalty with Luke Johnson. Back comes Levin.
It's nice when you have a young guy like Besser out killing penalties. But tells you a lot about what the coach thinks of the guy.
Right. Levin, number nine, battling there. Can't get in the puck. Fires into the North Dakota bench. Quinn Kesnick between the benches.
Yeah, Jim Montgomery leaned over the boards to get the attention of Cameron Voss, one of the referees, and he says, Vosser, how come we didn't take a look at that? Referring to the penalty against North Dakota. Voss turned to him and said, we both were on the same page that was just a two-minute penalty. No additional look was needed.
I agree. I think that's the right call there.
It was far enough away that he, you know, and it wasn't vicious. He could have certainly rifled him a lot harder.
Butcher.
Can't take everything out of the game.
Can't find a shooting lane. Wrist shot! Over the net. Here comes North Dakota the other way. Oh! It's onside. Behind the net is Chizik. Chizik. Gambrell comes in and swipes him clean. Chizik still battling though. Power play winding down. Moore is going to have Chizik on his back again. He'll go back to Butcher and see if the Pioneers can get something going for the first time. Good job by North Dakota again on the penalty kill. Heinen, Gambrell, beautiful move. The freshman, block shot. Puck loose in the slot. Backhander over the net.
Osmus made a great block on that one-on-one situation. Excellent job. Captain of the team, great Gage Osmus.
And he clears it there at the Shark draft. Gambrell, his hands are working right now.
Good, nice set of hands.
Slick. Heinen in front to Moore. Can't get it. Kept in towards the net. Wide of Johnson. Penalty over, but the pressure continues. And see if North Dakota can turn the tide and get a good scoring chance. They haven't had many here in the first. Hillman. Pioneers back in the zone. Jansen. Shore. Nice stick work by Osmus. He's got a strong shift. But that's going to be icing. North Dakota can't change. So we'll have to stay out there.
All those power plays, the shots are still 4-3. It's unbelievable.
It really is.
This game is crazy, man. A lot of shots have missed the net, but that's due to guys being in the shooting lane because you got to miss them so the puck ends up missing the net. But to have this few amount of saves by the two goaltenders, wow. And right now it looks like 12-9 at the end of the third period, the shots.
Matt Marcinou, Jared Lucas-Savages, and Grant Arnold back out there for Denver. And they're going to win the faceoff and control things. Savages. It's going to come to Zajac. He should be able to keep that in. He does. But then it comes out. Good job there by number 22, Rhett Gardner. Here's Osmus. Throws it up the wall. Sanderson tries to poke it out. He can. Trevor Olsen can't get it deep. Back the other way. Lucas-Savages gets whacked. But the Pioneers regain control. Deflected up into the netting as Romig from Vienna, Austria. His shot is tipped. John Butchergast, Barry Melrose here in Tampa. Steve Levy back in Connecticut.
Yes, with Messrs. Richland and Starman, and a lot of good little plays. We need a great big play. Seven shots on goal so far combined.
We're seeing a lot of skill from Denver offensively as they have the man advantage, but for North Dakota, some good block shots there late in that period.
I think one of the X factors in this game is North Dakota's Tucker Poolman. I think Denver's made him defend a lot, haven't allowed him to rush the puck, get involved in the play, and create havoc.
You know, Quinnipiac's watching. They're looking for their opponent in the championship game Saturday night on ESPN2. More first period coming up after this.
No score here in Tampa. Let's head down to Victoria Arland. Victoria.
Thank you. Senior defenseman Nolan Zajac comes from quite the hockey family. All three of his older brothers have collectively made it to the Frozen Four six times, but have come short of that national title. So I am joined by the hockey patriarch himself, Tom Zajac. Tom, thank you for joining me.
Thank you, welcome.
So what is it like watching your son Nolan play for Denver, your alma mater?
Well, it's great to watch him play just for anybody, but for Denver, sure, I've been here and played in Denver. It's great to see him play, especially at the Final Four.
Has there been a rivalry with the boys?
Oh, yeah. They're all awesome. Always at home. They were always fighting it growing up and going to the rinks and playing shinny hockey against each other. So, yeah, they grew up fighting.
So you were a forward and your three older sons are forwards. How did Nolan venture to the dark side and become a defenseman?
Well, he wanted to be a goalie. And then because his brothers were older, so they were shooting on somebody. And he had to be the goalie. But then he decided after being a goalie that it wasn't much fun back there. So he decided to go defense. He said, at least then I can try to score some goals.
All right. Well, thank you, Tom. Guys?
Thanks, Victoria. This is Ajax. We're from Winnipeg, Manitoba. All could have played Canadian junior, but they all played college.
Yeah, it's funny. That doesn't happen very often in Canada. I can certainly tell you which is the smartest kid. The defenseman.
Yeah, of course.
Way smarter than forwards.
Big line out there for North Dakota. Here comes Schmaltz. That's offside.
We have seen a lot of offsides.
Getting a top played in the 70s. Of course, Travis and Darcy both played at North Dakota. And then we saw, of course, Kelly at Union.
Yep.
We saw him play.
Wow, what a different group of schools. The two hockey schools, of course, North Dakota. Union is an entirely different ball game. Denver is more like North Dakota. But it's funny, you would think that all four would go to the same school, you know, especially when you got the first two going to North Dakota, but the father went to Denver. Why didn't they all go to Denver? So there's a lot of, you know, nuances to that story. I'd like to talk to the father and hear about.
Yeah, North Dakota did recruit Nolan, but he never took an official visit. And here he is at Denver where dad played.
And then how does Union get in the mix?
Yeah, great school.
Yeah. No scholarships.
Yeah, he had a nice career with some great teammates there as well. No score here. First period winding down.
This has been a crazy period. It's been a fun period to watch. Very entertaining. But again, we're sitting here, shots 4-3 at the time of the game.
Yeah.
It's nuts.
You can see the skill with the hands, the hockey sense, but it just hasn't translated yet. But again, this game could break out at any moment. We saw one glimpse there where they went up and down three
times. When
they
had the two-on-ones each way. Yeah.
Otherwise, it's been basically kind of a chess match. Again, these teams have seen each other a lot. They know the tendencies. There's really no more secrets anymore or any mysteries. Matt Van Voorhis. Nice moves to the zone.
That's what Denver's looking for, North Dakota's looking for right there. That mistake at center ice where they can go to the net.
Heinen gets it poked away. Here comes Rhett Gardner. He's got help. Gardner, shot saved and poked away and back the other way. Here comes Denver more. Gambrell to the front, never got there. Slaps it around, but there's Schmaltz.
On a 4-on-1, like North Dakota had, the goalie's playing the shooter. That's what he has to do. And then you're just hoping and praying for a break, and that's exactly what happened there. The rebound didn't go out to a player for North Dakota.
Schmaltz, dangerous with the puck. He still has it. He's taking a lap. Loses it there. Besser in front. It's loose. Knocked it around and goes into the corner. Marcinou's trying to get it out. That fourth line of Denver is now pinned in their own end. Butcher and Zajac are on defense. Here's Ledoux. Oh, and it slips out. And Denver's able to change.
Butcher actually attacked the man behind the net. You're not really supposed to do that. You're supposed to tie and stay in front of the net and pick that guy up. Let the goaltender play the guy coming out. But Butcher went after the man behind the net, and the pass hit him in the skate, and harmlessly went in the corner.
Zajac, time winding down here in the first period. Still no score. Denver and North Dakota. Simonson goes in after it. Battles there with Hammond. Behind the net, helping is Terry. Good support right there by Troy Terry late in a period. One more rush. Turned over, back the other way. Wrist shot over the net by Shane Gersich. And the first period ends scoreless. Tied in shots, four each. And no goals for each team, Barry. Bit of an unexpected turn of events.
This is the best eight-shot period I've ever seen in my life. It's unbelievable the amount of effort that was seen. Puck comes in the slot right there. We got men back. Puck only gets to the net once. Cam Johnson on his back makes a save. I love this fact. You got to shoot high on these goaltenders on the butterfly. If you don't, it hits a helmet or goes over the net. Gillette equally as good at his end. The four shots he saw. I love that save. His job is to take the shooter, not to worry about anything else. And you can do that when your defensemen are helping you out and doing the job properly. Right here is probably the best chance for Denver to score. The puck was everywhere, and it hopped out in front. Nobody was near him. And Zajac, as I said, the puck didn't bounce out to a North Dakota player. It bounced out to Zajac. He cleared out of harm's way.
Quint Kesnick with Grant Arnold, the captain.
Barry just called that the best eight-shot period that he's seen in a long time. How would you best characterize what we just saw?
Yeah, I think that's Denver hockey at its best. You know, we're playing fast. I think we're doing as good as we can against them. They're a great team, and they're fast as well. So a little unhappy with the odd man rushes we gave them, but, you know, we got a couple too. It's 0-0 after one. It's a great hockey game.
You spin this thing forward. What do you say to your teammates? What can make the difference?
Yeah, I think we got to get the puck in on the red line and blue lines, and we got to get to their blue paint. We got to get a dirty goal, a nasty goal. And, you know, it's playoff time. That's the kind of goals that are scored in these games.
Thank you, Grant.
Thank you.
Bucci.
Grant Arnold tiling off, and both teams got to figure out how to make this work. Not a lot of room to move so far. No score in Tampa. Back to Connecticut, Sean Richland, Dave Starman, Steve Levy.
Bucci, thanks. Make sure Barry gets a big tub of popcorn. Much as it pains me to agree with him, there was plenty of action up and down. I'm not one of those guys who subscribes to the fact you got to have a ton of goals for exciting hockey. Usually I'm good with scoring chances, whether they go in or not. I like some shots on goal. What do we make of that first period, Dave?
I think this is a typical Denver-North Dakota game. They're both playing it tight, and they can. I think one guy who's been great in this game has been Ayton White, Nick Schmaltz. Look at him coming back on a penalty kill. This is a guy that couldn't buy his way onto the penalty kill last year. He forced North Dakota with his defensive play to put him on the penalty kill this year, and he gets a scoring chance out of it. Now, watch him in a defensive posture. Ayton White tracks back, picks up the stick of Grant Arnold, then gets to the front of the net and is able to help out on the defensive side. Nick Schmaltz is going to be a key in this game in that respect.
And Dave, Denver offensively, watch on the man advantage how they control the play into the zone, the way they rush. This is the pack rim line. Watch Danton Heinen, he hesitates here. Gets the blue line, stops, and Butcher maneuvers the puck in. They like to have puck possession in the offensive zone, and I thought in the first period they did a great job of puck possession. North Dakota kept them to the outside, but if the pack rim line continues to have this type of puck possession and offensive chances, it's going to be a long night for North Dakota.
Go ahead, Dave.
And Steve, one of the things we talked about in the early game with Denver, getting to that third circle. They didn't get a lot of pucks and people to the front of the net. That's something they'll emphasize between periods.
And again, for those who might have missed, the third circle is in between the two circles down low in front of the net.
That is correct. And Jim Montgomery has talked about that a lot. And he said when we're successful, we get a lot of people into that third circle, pucks and people to the front of the net.
North Dakota trying to break through. They've lost six straight appearances in the national semifinal game where they find themselves once again tonight. Who wants a shot at Quinnipiac for the national championship on Saturday night? We'll look back to the early game next. Scoreless after 20 minutes, North Dakota and Denver. Earlier tonight, Boston College and top-seeded Quinnipiac for the right to play for the national championship. First period. Is that offside? We'll take another look at it. BC's going to turn it over, and that leads to the Kevin McKernan goal.
Tough turnover there behind the net. Poor communication between goaltender Demko and his D-man, but Quinnipiac, a little bit offsides here on the replay. You see, they got away with one there, but they took advantage of it, and they did a great job on the forecheck for the remainder of the game.
And once again, as they did last weekend, second wave, second layer, Quinnipiac's defense becoming actively involved in scoring opportunities.
I call this a beautiful pass, but you could call it terrible defensive zone coverage. Which way do you guys want to go on that?
It's a combination of both here. Great setup down low by Quinnipiac, but look at the four guys looking at the puck, and you know, you work on that constantly to have your head on a swivel in the D zone, and no swivels were available.
How'd that get through? After winning the faceoff deflection, and Landon Smith, and there's the insurance goal. BC would score late to make it a one-goal game, but it's Quinnipiac moving on. Landon Smith with Quinn Kasenich.
What was working in that first period?
I think all the boys were buzzing. I think we were rolling four lines and everybody was pulling their weight, and that's when we're successful, is when everybody's doing what they can do. I think that's why we were so successful in the first.
Momentum kind of slipped there in the third period. You guys spent way too much time in the penalty box. What was it like holding on?
I wouldn't say holding on necessarily. I think we just switched the way we need to play. Like you said, we got a couple of penalties, so we had to bear down on the penalty kill, and we were fortunate enough to do so.
Do the hustle. Do the handed hustle, everybody. This was a tight one for Quinnipiac, but they have been dominating teams this season. They've now outscored opponents. How about 162-80? That's almost twice as many goals. I was told there'd be no math. And Quinnipiac is moving on. All right, fellas, to me, the story of the game turned out to be that first period. BC made a couple of mistakes, even with the offside, and Boston College couldn't overcome, and Quinnipiac took advantage.
They did, but BC really struggled to overcome the first period. I felt like they came out in the second period, got the power play goal, they were moving, and then what happened? They took a penalty, and they sat back, and Quinnipiac then took it to them the rest of the game, and it was hard to get back into it. Maybe thought they had a push at the end, but give Quinnipiac a lot of credit. This is a team with three losses on the year. They know how to close games.
I agree, and I think one of the things that they did well in this game, a couple things. Number one is their goaltender played big when he had to. I thought that was a key component. Number two is I thought their puck pursuit, their relentlessness, what Rand Pecknold wants from them, was excellent. And number three is they have shown a real propensity this year for not allowing teams that like to play flow-style hockey to get their flow going. Yale, Harvard, BC, all really good offensive teams. Quinnipiac was able to be good between the blue lines and not allow them to flow.
Now, neither of one of you have actually told me this, but I get the sense that you both believe the winner of tonight's game will win on Saturday night. They didn't say that. That's just my impression. We'll be right back.
Hey, America, I'm getting fired up for Golden Corral's new Fired Up Favorites. It's endless ribs, wings, and tenders and bold new flavors like habanero, sriracha, garlic parmesan, and classic buffalo. Fired Up Favorites only at Golden Corral.
Lowe's one-year guarantee on plants means anyone can have a beautiful garden. Finally, something in this yard as beautiful as me. Enjoy.
Now get perennials 3 for $10 at Lowe's.
Smoltz, 1-1.
Wrist shot.
Gambrell, shot. Arnold walks in, throws in front. Johnson covers up, is it in? Welcome back to the 2016 NCAA Frozen Four, presented by Northwestern Mutual. 8 shots on goal, ties a record.
How many?
8. Ties a record for fewest shots by both teams in regulation. John Butchergoss and Barry Melrose here live in Tampa. And Barry, Denver in that first period, both teams, some tough sledding. Denver had a couple interesting line changes.
Boy, Denver, they press the limit when they're talking about line change. What I mean by that, when the puck is thrown in deep and they get a change, they load the ice with people. Watch right here. Puck goes in, it gets away from the Denver bench. Now, Denver wants a change. Look at it. Looks like Garth Brooks' concert. They just opened the doors. Everybody's out there. 8 guys on the ice. Doesn't get caught because the puck doesn't come back. Now let's do it again. North Dakota gets it. Denver again making the changes. They got 7 guys on the ice this time. But now watch how sneaky North Dakota is. Puck goes up the wall. A North Dakota player gets it. Denver's going to go in for one of those mass changes. He throws it back up the bench. That's a great, great move by the North Dakota player right there to try and create a too many men on the ice penalty. So I'm sure they've been talked about it by the referees. They see the same thing we do, and we'll see if maybe something is called in the second period.
Denver had a couple power plays. North Dakota still looking for theirs. As you can see, there's that record that we've tied, that we told you about.
Glad I was here to see it.
The 96 title game between Michigan and Colorado College.
And those are two great offensive schools, too.
That was a 1-0 championship game as well. This could be a 1-0 semifinal game.
That'd be a terrible save percentage if this was 1-0.
All right, because I'm curious to see what this second period will look like after that first period. Here comes Denver, threatening in front off the skate, goes back behind the net. As Tarik Hammond came in deep. Here's Quentin Shore, number 27. He centers Troy Terry and Evan Jansen, but Besser had it. Terry throws it back in. Besser up to Kajula. Kajula back to Schmaltz. Here comes Schmaltz. Here's where he's dangerous. Has it. He got room. Schmaltz throws it back. Wrist shot. Goes wide. Boy, as Kajula was there. Good back check there by Matt Marcinou, number 23.
That's passing up a great scoring chance to make a pass. It would have been plays in the night if it would have went in, but.
Pioneers, oh, what a nice play there by number two, Troy Stetcher. In front, shot, score! Drake Kajula! Senior leadership makes it 1-0 North Dakota.
Johnny, this is execution of a 2-on-1. Couldn't be any better. Great job. The band's fired up. Everybody's going down North Dakota sidelines. Kajula had such a great start to this game. You can see what he means to this team. That line's fantastic. Now you're going to see the stretch pass up the wall. The forwards are taking off. And there's Kajula jumping through the middle. Denver forwards got a little lazy there. They lost their men in transition. Besser makes a great pass to Kajula. And Kajula beats the goaltender. Gillette right there on the far side. Just great execution. One side of the ice to the other. Back into the middle. Kajula goes in, and that's a guy who wanted to have a breakaway. Great execution by North Dakota.
They're jumping up and down in Whitby, Ontario, as Kajula gets his 22nd goal of the year, 59th of his North Dakota career. And they strike first, 1-0 against Denver.
Well, let's see if Denver's got an answer now. That was a little bit of a hack.
Plenty of firepower, and here's Heinen protecting the puck along the boards, but taken by Gardner. Besser and Sanderson get assists on the Kajula goal. Towards the net again. Just wide. Pagansky, soft one in there, just out of reach.
Good defensive play by Ledoux, tying up the stick, not taking a penalty.
And see if that adds to the energy for both teams, and maybe we'll see some more.
I'm energized. I'm charged. Yeah. I'm ready to
turn over in front. Backhander goes wide. Chizik had a chance. He throws it back in there behind the net.
North Dakota's taking over, Johnny.
They are. Janet Tweed in the fin. North Dakota, definitely the loudest of the four schools here in Tampa. Another look at the goal, Barry. Brock Besser, the first round pick from Vancouver. Saucing over to Drake Kajula.
Yeah, he's known to have a big shot. You don't really expect him to make that nice saucer pass, landing flat in the tape for Kajula, but you see the skill of the big guy.
And look at his career against Denver, Barry. In 17 games, 17 points, leads all active Dakota players.
I got to think his numbers against any team that he's played quite a bit are pretty good. The guy's a fantastic talent.
He's a big-time player. Look, very relaxed. When we talked to him yesterday, career winding down, see what's up in the professional level. Multiple NHL teams are interested. I heard Ottawa might be the favorite right now.
He's a guy, no matter what happens, can go over to Europe and make a lot of money at the end of his career.
So let's see if the pack rim line can get Denver back on the board. Jim Montgomery knows how important the next goal is. But now Gabe Levin's out here. This line started the game. Romig, Staub, and Levin. Rink has definitely been energized by that goal by Kajula. Jansen. Thompson gets it out there. Keaton Thompson, number four. Here he is again, the Anaheim Duck draft pick. No. Tipped in deep. Quentin Shore rims it around. Glove back in. Here comes Ajak, the defenseman. Makes a move to space, falls down. No penalty called. Puck in. North Dakota Stetcher looks to turn away. Turnover. Puck in front. Tied up in front. Schmaltz, great defensive play. Digging. The whistle blows.
Johnny, that was a great defensive play.
Nick Schmaltz and saved the goal.
And the guy didn't get a penalty. Schmaltz didn't get a penalty on the play either. Even if he would have got a penalty, it would have still been a great defensive
play. Was that hooking or not? Close. I don't think so.
I How could it not be? How do you stop that guy without taking a penalty? That's what I mean. Let's take another look on the side in front of the net.
Maybe just didn't quite get to him.
Boy.
Wow.
Like I said, even if he takes a penalty, I don't care. That's well worth it. Wide open net looked like it was going to be a 6x4.
Yeah, I think he didn't put that stick in front. Live, it looked like he stuck his stick in front, but I don't think he did.
I was just taking it for granted it was going
to
be a penalty.
Oh, Heinen, what a play to Gambrell. Here comes Gambrell. Try to go back to Moore. Get tied up, though. Good play by Ledoux. And Ledoux still has it. Protects it. Gets it out. Here comes Pagansky, the Blues pick. Austin Pagansky can't go wide. At the point. Pullman. Behind the net. Good defensive play. North Dakota screaming for a penalty. Barry wants that next call, but looked like a good no call there. Butcher throws it up. Teams trying to take advantage, Barry, of a neutral zone turnover to create offense. You see, it's hard to get going off the ice, it seems, for both teams.
No, because there's so much traffic in the neutral zone. That's why a turnover is so much easier to create an offensive chance on when you got to go 100 feet.
Here comes Besser. Hit by Garneau behind. First line against the fourth line here. Marcinou. Rims it around. Keaton Thompson has it. Smaltz. Arnold slap shot blocked by the left boot of Pullman, who stuck his leg out to block that pass. Zajac. Arnold. He'll get it deep. Luke Johnson walking down the tunnel. He collided with Brock Besser.
That could do it.
So we'll see.
Besser's a pretty big guy.
Besser throws it across. Change off the bench. Throws it across back to Besser. Goes back to the point to Thompson. Thompson wrist shot wide. Besser's going to get it, though. Oh, it just spins off him, and Denver's able to get it out. Here they come. 2-on-2. Now maybe a late developing 3-on-2. Plant. Never gets it.
Oh, there's almost too many men again. If one of them touched that puck, that's a too many men on the ice penalty.
Bradbury screaming to the top of the bench. He wants that call. He's been asking for it all game, really. Levin forechecking. Roaming out there as well for Denver. Drake Kajula has made it 1-0 North Dakota in a tight checking affair. Not a lot of chances. Here comes Stetcher. Gillette gloves that. He'll hold on. So much intensity in this rivalry game. Kajula, including tonight, his last 12 games, he has 7 goals. He's hot. North Dakota leads.
CAA Frozen 4 is presented by Northwestern Mutual. We help you live life differently.
North Dakota is college hockey. 7 titles, 1959. Bob May's team beat Michigan State in overtime, 1963. Barry Thordycraft was the head coach. They beat Denver, 1980, beating Northern Michigan, 82. Wisconsin is defeated, 87. Michigan State goes down, 1997. Dean Blaze beats BU. Blaze again beats BC in Providence, by the way. In the year 2000! What a program, what a great fan base. There it is, most titles all time. One of these teams hoping to make it 8, Barry.
Dean Blaze beats anything with a B in it. Great coach. Great history. I play with a lot of guys from North Dakota. Tremendous history. They all love it there. It really seemed to me like if I was going to go to a college program, it would be a place like North Dakota. They just have such a great time there, and they always have a good team.
So Colton Sanderson moves up to play with Pagansky and Gardner as Luke Johnson left the game. We'll see if he returns. Puck sent in deep. Adam Plant behind the net. North Dakota trying to provide the pressure. Careful, almost a hold there, but avoided in the last second. Here's Sanderson again. Colton Sanderson, the senior. Moose Jaw, Saskatchewan.
Very nice town, Moose Jaw. And he played in Weyburn, Saskatchewan, where I played.
He's a walk-on. Battling. 34th game of the year for Colton. Trying to finish off his...
Goal! Holy shnikes! Bar down! Hands up! It's Kajula again!
There looked like there was absolutely no offense possible on this play. The puck was in the corner, it was being batted around, it was being kicked, it was being whacked, no one had a handle on it. And Kajula, just like a little thief, goes in there, steals the puck out, and beats everyone to the front of the net. and just throws a beautiful shot up under the bar. There's that pass off the wall, and there's the thief coming in there in the middle of the night, steals the puck, and throws up under the bar. What a goal.
Ooh.
What a player.
That is a twisted wrister.
I think it might have hit a couple mints too, John.
Maybe.
Maybe a couple mints up there.
About a mint and a half.
That was quick, man. That two steps off the wall, right up, right up.
So North Dakota with their fourth shot on goal of the period. Two have gone in as Kajula, second tonight. He's got a 12-game point streak. It's an unassisted goal. He's getting hot at just the right time for a North Dakota program trying to get off the schneid here. It's been too long for a national championship. Maybe this is the year. See how Denver responds. First game, Barry, you saw Boston College fall down 2-0. They responded with the third goal of the game. Still wasn't enough in the end. This time of year, it's hard to fall behind good teams and come all the way back.
Well, and Denver's already had a goal-scoring chance so far. You know, they've had five shots. None of them quality, Harley. A couple scrambles. But other than that, they haven't had any prolonged attacking time at all.
I tell you, Barry, we are seeing a difference between Dave Hackstall and Brad Berry behind the bench. Brad is the top button is undone. The jacket is open.
He's a little bigger than Dave, too.
He's on the top turnbuckle. He's on the bench.
He's a little more menacing looking than Dave.
Sweats more.
And I'm not sure Dave would ever wear that tie.
That is a tie. But his team now playing with passion, playing with purpose, and leading 2-0. You saw Jim Montgomery, arms folded, scratching the head, trying to come up with something.
Well, they got to get one.
Yep, it's all it takes.
Lots of time left, half a game left. They've only given up 8 shots, so. But obviously they need the next one. Very simple equation.
Here comes Terry. He'll exit the zone. Look at that puck pursuit by North Dakota. Multiple players, hunted down.
They're feeling it, John.
They're definitely energized. But here come the Pioneers. Jansen. Evan Jansen from Green Bay, Wisconsin, number 26. Out there with Quentin Shore and Troy Terry. Back comes North Dakota with the puck. Dumping it in. Hillman will go back with it.
Smart play right there. It's a 1-on-3 dump and chase.
Wrap around. Goes wide from Sanderson. Colton Sanderson's been active. Ledoux. One-timer. Caught by Gillette through traffic in front as Tucker Pullman sent one to the net. Hey, coverage of the NCAA championships continues with the Bowling National Championship Saturday, April 16th on ESPNU at 6:30 Eastern. More information, go to NCAA.com.
Denver's losing this, Johnny. They're losing all the battles now. They look slower, not as quick, not as aggressive. This is a big time in the game, turning point in the game. If Denver wants to stay in it, they got to push back and get that next goal. Right now, it looks like North Dakota sort of having their way with Denver.
Shots this period, 5, North Dakota, 1, Denver.
An onslaught.
Zajac. D to Hammond. Loses it, but Zajac is there, trying to get the red line. He can't even get over the red line to get it in deep, but Denver gets it back. Now they don't get
it
back.
Twice.
Turnover back and forth. Here they go again now. They'll try again. Good speed around the outside. Roman. Right,
3 times. That's 3 times they got to center ice and didn't get it in, John. You got to change that, man.
Battling in the corner. Stetcher throws it across just off the bench. Osmond slapper into the gut of Gillette. North Dakota shot 10 now of the game. 6th of the period. It's been all North Dakota.
And more so every couple minutes, North Dakota's taking it to them. They look faster, they look more aggressive, more creative. They just, North Dakota is doing everything they want right now. Denver's got to get back to basics. You get to center, you haven't got to play. It goes in, you go and win the physical battles, outwork them, get the puck to the net, get back to the basics here.
Shot!
Win draws.
Over the net, another scoring opportunity. That was Besser with that wrist shot.
And that's a set play off the draw. He's on his forehand side over there, so.
Schmaltz, great feet, great hands as he protects the puck. There's Kajula looking for a hat trick all of a sudden. Besser throws the backhand through the blue paint. Here comes Stetcher, always aggressive. Wrist shot again into the belly of Gillette.
Yeah, look at Kajula right around the front of the net right there. He's not a perimeter player. He sticks his nose in there. Not scared to get hacked and whacked in order to score a goal. So Right now, boy, North Dakota's feeling it. They see tomorrow. They see Saturday right now. Denver's got to take it away.
You mentioned Quentin Shore's younger brother, Baker. Rob Sanderson, the play-by-play man of the Chicago Steel, tweeting at us, Barry, that Baker's going to make his USHL debut Friday for the Chicago Steel tomorrow. So the Shore family, a hockey family, one of the really great college hockey families. Three down, one to go.
That's the fourth one, yeah?
Yeah. Parents David and Sarah getting a lot of Scully help from their kids.
Yes, they are.
Saving them a lot of clinks.
See if the Pioneers now can get something going here. Levan throws it towards the net. 3.9 grade point average, finance major at Denver. Looking at law school. Next.
That's our buddy?
Yeah, already accepted to Harvard Law. He's going to try other places. But so far, Harvard's a leader in the clubhouse.
He's an entertainment star. He's got his own show.
If Heidelberg had a law school, I'm sure he'd pick Heidelberg University. we're still working on that.
If Heidelberg had a gym, he might go there.
Yeah, well, we have a gym.
Well, you got a gym now? Yeah. That's good, dear.
Holy 2,100. Heinen. Pack rim line. Denver needs a goal. They need it now. Outside the zone. Hillman retreats. They got some room to go now as North Dakota changes one player. Thompson tries to get it up, but Moore gets it. Gambrell back to Heinen trying to battle. And he throws it in front, but cleared out by North Dakota.
No chances. Puck's in the zone. Real no chances to score off it.
Simonson was there to clear that puck. All right, here's Gambrell. Been a little quieter this period after he was a really active first period with some chances. Oh, boy. Denver had 6 men on the ice again.
I just watched him change now. It's great.
That was the most blatant one there.
It's like a fire drill over there on the change, man. That's great.
Brad Berry's been begging for that call.
People are diving over the boards and jumping in the door.
Denver trying to break here. Almost. Grant Arnold almost had a breakaway. Goes behind the net, soft chip, but he chips it into the corner. Kept alive there by Marcini. Taken out by Ledoux. Arnold heads back in there, hacking and whacking. Arnold throws it. Oh, trying to throw it off the back of Johnson, but it gets deflected wide. Good play by Ledoux. Shot! Pad saved by Johnson. Calm and cool. Goes down and kicks it out off the Butcher shot. Here's Butcher again.
It didn't look like Johnson saw that Butcher shot. But again, positioning is 90% goaltending with these giant goaltenders.
It'll be hard for Denver at this point to even get 2 goals, much less the 3 they'll now need to win and get to the national championship game Saturday on ESPN2 against Quinnipiac, who beat Boston College earlier today. Arnold will rim it in and go change. Quentin Shore. Behind the net it goes. Roman back in front. North Dakota has it chipped up by Kajula. He wanted to send Besser deep, but Besser didn't see it until too late. And back to get it is Hammond.
Smart play, though. Very creative right there by Kajula. You see a lot of other weapons he has, not just a guy that can shoot. Very, very smart with the puck.
Terry throws it in front. Redirected save by Johnson. As you heard, the faceoff goes outside the zone as number 26, Evan Jansen, crashes into Johnson and the net.
Stetcher made that play. Stetcher really bothered him, made sure the puck didn't get to him clean. Doesn't look like there's a penalty on the play either.
Nope, so just outside the zone.
Good job by Stetcher right there. Got inside positioning, didn't take a penalty, and really didn't give Heinen a chance to see the puck properly or make a good play.
7 shots on goal for North Dakota this period. 4 for Denver. We talked about the CBS line before the game. It's been all about the C.
That's some great writing.
Drake Kajula. 2-0 North Dakota.
Attention, structured settlement recipients. Are you receiving future payments from a settled lawsuit? Do you receive annuity payments spread out over a long period of time? Turn those payments into a large lump sum of money. Call CBC Settlement Funding now. If you qualify, you could be eligible for an immediate $1,000 fast-track advance. Call CBC now to discuss your free, no-obligation options.
Call 1-800-215-8787. That's 1-800-215-8787.
Never be the same.
John Butchergoss, Barry Melrose, North Dakota feeling good. They're up 2-0. Brad Berry took over for Dave Haxtell this year. He was a North Dakota defenseman in the mid-80s. Became an assistant coach 4 years after graduation. Had an assistant coach. Got the job last May, and he's with Quint Kestner.
Coach, what's been the big difference between the first period and the second period in terms of the way you're kind of dominating play?
Undoubtedly, puck management. First period, we were a little bit jittery there. We were turning pucks over, not managing the puck very well. Our end of the rink, we did a good job of second man quick, moving pucks up, good support. We got to get pucks moving north. Continue to do that.
How do you best describe the impact that Drake has had on this game?
Well, he's a game breaker. You know, we've seen that time and time again in his career. He makes plays out of nothing. He's got a quick, strong stick to turn over pucks, and when he gets it, it's in the net.
Thanks, Coach.
Thanks.
You said he was an off-the-glass and out kind of player. His first NHL game was in the Met Center as a member of the Jets. And, he got the job when Dave Haxtell got the Flyer job, and he's done a great job in his first year bringing North Dakota to the Frozen Four, and now...
And Haxtell's done a great job in Philadelphia.
Certainly has.
Good move by everybody.
And now a chance to get his team to the championship game. Pagansky is out there with Rhett Gardner. Luke Johnson still not back yet. He left earlier down the tunnel and hasn't played since. Offside is called at the line. Face off just outside the North Dakota zone. 7:40 left here in the second period.
That was a great pass. That's what they have to do against this swarming defense in North Dakota. You got to spring them up the middle like that. There's not much room. It's got to be tape to tape. It can't be in the skates or anything like that. If that would have been a little bit more on the tape, that would have been a good scoring chance by Denver. So it's something that we can look for Denver trying to do a little bit more often. But North Dakota is really plugging up the neutral zone. Really good.
They have taken over this game, every aspect of it. The gritty structure, which is the foundation really these days for any good hockey team, and then to have that one or two guys who can electrically score a goal like Drake Kajula has.
Yep.
And that's what you always say, your best player's got to be your best players, and that's why.
Guys that don't need a lot of chances to score this time of year.
It's hard.
Best of one.
It's hard to score this time of year at every level. And you need guys that are good at it. Drake Kajula certainly is. And that line is back out there now. See if Denver can get something going here. Make this a one-goal game. Behind the net. Romig in front. Doesn't get there. Romig and Staub and Levin. They started this game for Denver. Getting some pressure here. Aggressive catch by Plant, the defenseman. But he keeps it in. Adam Plant trying to find somebody open. He can't. Tried to get it to Terry. He couldn't do it. Pressure continues. Throws it across. And Boris aggressively pitching. Denver now stepping on the gas pedal, trying to apply some pressure. Next stop is trying to get a quality shot.
One step at a time.
Yeah, one step at a time. Keaton Thompson will softly get it out. Puck goes up in the air. Jansen throws it in.
Good zone time, good possession time. No shot at net.
Terry has it in front. What a diving breakup play by Keaton Thompson. What a play by number four. That's icing. Face off to the right of Cam Johnson.
Keaton Thompson's had a great game. When you're looking at North Dakota, you're not looking at Keaton Thompson. You're looking at Stetcher, you're looking at Ledoux, you're looking at Pullman, you're looking at Osmuth, and quietly, Keaton Thompson's been great. And this is what I talked about. It comes across, stick on the ice. If that puck gets through, that's going to be a very tough save for the goaltender, Johnson. But you see the stick, great stick in the lane, good help. Very strong game for Thompson. When you're 5 and 6 defensemen are doing that for you, you got a really good hockey team.
So again, the story of this game, really, it's Drake Kajula. Two opportunities, Barrett, he finishes.
Yeah, great line. You see what we talked about, this line being one of the best lines in the nation. Besser throws it over there. Kajula finishes it off really quick. We talked about him stealing the puck in the corner. Two strides later, it's up under the bar. Just a great goal scorer's goal. Very tough to defend against a kid that can do all the things he can do. And again, he's got so gutty, so tough. You know, he sticks his nose in. One highlight we showed you, he's the guy in front of the net supplying the screen. Your offensive juggernaut. So that's what you love about a little guy like him when he plays hard like he does.
Quinn Kestick with more.
Super impressed with his maturity when we met with him yesterday, working that playoff beard and a leader. He said this version of North Dakota, he thinks has a better chance to take home the national title because of their depth, which I thought was ironic given that they have 11 freshmen on the roster.
Well, they're good. Four shot save by Johnson, who looks very good in net.
That might be Moore's first chance to score a goal in this game, man.
It really was.
They've controlled him very well.
Ledoux skates it out. Back in the Denver end. They try to get something going here with their big line, the Pac Rim line. Danton Heinen, British Columbia. Dylan Gambrell from Washington State. And Trevor Moore from Thousand Oaks, California. Here's Heinen. He's dangerous. Throws in front on the feet of Moore. Can't get it. And out comes North Dakota. Just comes out of the zone, but back comes Moore. Heinen will skate it down. Can't quite get there in time. Comes out by the Wisconsin logo. Wisconsin is the host school. Obviously, there's not a Division I program nearby. It was Alabama-Huntsville last time, but it gives the folks of Wisconsin a chance to get some warm weather.
By the way, good luck, Tony Granato, coaching Wisconsin next year.
Shot! Shoulder save, Gillette! Off a high wrist shot, and back comes Denver. Butcher leads the charge, the defenseman number four. Onside, looking, can't get it through. What a great job by North Dakota. Their structure is outstanding, and they're making it very difficult for Denver to get anything accomplished. Denver keeps plugging along here, and we got a penalty coming up. Hooking is the call. The Denver Pioneers will go on the power play. It's Gage Ausmus heads to the box. Steve Levy's in Connecticut.
Bucci, thank you. With the fellas. So Drake Kajula, nobody wanted to draft him in the NHL. What are those guys doing?
Undrafted, this kid has been sensational all year. He's one of the most exciting players in college hockey, without a doubt.
We talk about late bloomers. This kid had 2 years where he went to prove himself, and his last 2 years, he's been off the charts. Drake Kajula, highlights are us.
No question. Coming up in the intermission, whoever goes on to win this game tonight will get a crack at Quinnipiac for the national championship. We'll show you what Quinnipiac did earlier. That's coming up.
Welcome to Tampa. North Dakota leads 2-0, but about to kill a penalty. John Butchergoss and Barry Melrose with you. The winner of this game will play the Quinnipiac Bobcats from Hamden, Connecticut. They beat Boston College. Quinnipiac is in the title game. First team since 1993 Maine with fewer than four losses. His teams have never met.
How could Quinnipiac could possibly play two teams they've never played before to win the national championship?
Yeah.
That's weird.
It's going to happen. Up-and-coming program. And like to play anybody. Like we said, they're going to start a series with Boston College. Power play Denver. They need one now. Moore. Shot. Save Johnston. Rebound in front. Terry tries to poke it in. The puck is loose. It's loose. But cleared.
Good job by the referee not blowing the whistle there, because I didn't think he could see it. He was behind the net. Must have been some communication between him and the other referee.
Here,
was laying there.
Here comes Denver. Terry. Shot wide. Wow. What a stretch pass. Here comes Heinen on the power play now. Heinen stopped by Ledoux, but he gets it back. Moore, Butcher. Butcher shot, blocked in front, never got there. Moore, Terry. Butcher wants it. Terry goes to Moore, shot just wide. Yeah, Johnson beat. Terry. Heinen across, Moore. Goes in front, shot saved by Johnson. Robbing Dylan Gambrell.
Great job by Denver. They're doing exactly what they need to do. Puck control, men in front, screening the goaltender, getting the shots they wanted. There's two saves right there. Johnson's standing tall in net. He's very aggressive right there. Excellent job by Denver, but again, Johnson's playing so strong in net. Puck comes across. Boy, again, if it was more in the wheelhouse, he could have one-timed that. Johnson has the post tied up. Great work in front. A lot of help for the goaltender right there, Johnson, by his defenseman teammates helping him out on loose puck battles in front of the net.
Still plenty of time on the power play. Power play is so good in the regional. They need one now. Sajak. Hillman scored one. He walks in. Oh, he tried to pass it.
Hillman got two in the regionals.
Yeah, he tried to pass it to Levin, but Levin got tied up. Hillman again. One-timer. Blocked in front. Sliding block shot there by Tucker Pullman. Quinton Shore. Hillman. One-timer. Another block. Pullman again! Pullman again! He's a crash test dummy out there!
Three shot blocks right there. That was more saves than Johnson made in the first period.
He's a human futon. Hillman. Here comes Heinen. Heinen with room. Stopping, turning. That's what Jim Montgomery wants his team to do. Butcher throws it across. Gambrell. In front, Heinen. Tries again, but can't get it past Johnson Heinen had a couple of chances, puts the stick on top of his head and says, man, that might have been my chance.
And then all of a sudden you start thinking, if you're Denver, this just isn't our night, the way things are going. There's the one puck that gets the front and it goes back into the slot area. Pucks move to the side, middle, comes across. There's the first one. Wow. No fear right there, man. Came across, made an unbelievable save, Pullman did.
Zajac
made two more after that.
Power play winding down. Butcher across. Gambrell just out of his reach. Back to even strength, but a couple of seconds here. They have a little bit of chance, but Heinen in front. Zajac towards the net. Heinen almost had a tip as he strolled across the top of the crease, and North Dakota's going to be able to kill the penalty and get it out. But back comes Denver. Moore blocked again. North Dakota loading up on the block shots in this game. They got 14 to Denver's 4. Butcher to Moore. Active sticks and active bodies for North Dakota. They're laying it all on the line here in Tampa, trying to get to the championship game in Brad Berry's first year as head coach of North Dakota. Back the other way they come. Terry off wing wide. Back comes North Dakota. They got some skaters here. A little late developing 3-on-2. Cross. Keaton Thompson, the defenseman, was straight. He still has it. Throws in front. Almost tipped. Just wide. Johnny Simonson behind the net. In a tween and the Finn out there. And the slot shot. Never got there. Poked away. Terry kicks it out. Here he goes. Terry down the right wing. Looking for somebody. Toe drag shot. Just wide. Plant keeps it in. Behind the net, Grant Arnold will skate it down. Watched by Thompson. Arnold waiting for support from Marceneau.
Terry was dead in that rush. He had no juice left to make that play happen.
Legs were gone.
He just had to get to a shooting area and fire it.
Zajac, wrist shot, tipped. Just wide, side of the net. 1 minute left. North Dakota up 2-0, 2 second period goal from Jake Kajula. This will be icing. Faceoff back in the North Dakota end. Saturday, 3 Eastern, ESPN2, the 19th annual Nike Hoop Summit. USA Men's Junior Team takes on an international squad made up of the best players under 19. This is a chance to see some of the best high school players take on the best international players before they head to college and beyond. It's also on the apps.
All right, North Dakota's got to get out of this period 2-0. You can't give up a goal late in the period. It's always a killer. It's a momentum changer. You got 44 seconds, win another draw. Get out, go in, and get ready to go in the third period with a 2-0 lead.
Back-to-back icings by North Dakota.
Give it over to the band for intermissions. Get to the dressing room. Winning 2-0.
Matt Marceneau would take the faceoff for Denver, trying to win it, trying to get a couple more shots on goal. But once again, North Dakota will clear. Hayden Shaw gets it out of the zone, the freshman from Woodbury, Minnesota. Denver trying to get back in, but they're offside at the line.
A lot of offsides, man. Both games, we've seen a lot of offsides tonight.
Not a lot of room between the blue lines to make a play.
And everyone's trying to get the edge. You know.
Jim Montgomery trying to figure this out, Barry. How can I help here? What can I do?
Well, Jimmy's got plays off every draw, so yep. He needs to get that face off in the North Dakota end and use one of those plays. And obviously you can't give up another one, so it's sort of a catch 22. We got to score two.
The line juggling here now. We have Gambrell out there with Jansen. And with Shore. So again, he's trying to do something here. A little different combination. Butcher. Shore. Oh, back to the point. Zajac. Shore's open, one-timer, blocked. Pagansky high off the glass, Zajac keeps it in. Here's Shore again. Shore coming wide, goes around the net, looking for someone, didn't find anybody. Gambrell in there. Pagansky, and the period ends. Scoreless after one, Drake Kajula. Number 9 steals the show with 2 scintillating goals off a quick release wrist shot. Check this out. In fact, all of our teams in this Frozen Four haven't lost when leading after 2. They're all perfect.
Well, Drake Kajula has been the best player on the ice by either team. The kid's fantastic. I love this play. Besher makes a beautiful soft saucer pass over to Kajula. feathers it right by the goaltender. Excellent job right there. You see the skill of the guy, see his shooting ability. And right here, talk about him being a thief. He just steals that loose puck, two strides, good quick shot, catches the goaltender going down, throws it up over him. So just a great job. Cam Johnson, we love this guy. We talked to him yesterday, barrel of laughs, just having a great time. Very strong in net. Didn't see a lot of shots in the first period. Denver brought it the last 7 or 8 minutes of this period, especially on the power play. He made 3 or 4 really, really good saves in traffic right there in front of the net with Denver all around him.
Quinn Kesnick is with the star of the show.
Drake, a pair of second period goals. The first one was a 2-on-1. What happened?
Besser just made a good pass in behind the defenseman there and kind of had his mini breakaway. And scouting report was a shoot blocker side, so I just tried to get it off as quick as I can, and luckily I beat a blocker side.
Second one, a steal and a snipe. What did you see on that play that no one else did? Seemed like you were the only one moving towards the puck.
Yeah, I just I came off the bench, and I kind of surprised everyone. I just kind of hid behind some guys, and the D-man tried to make a pass up to the winger, and I just kind of picked his pocket and made a move around one D-man and just tried to get the puck on net. Unfortunately, it went under his glove.
What was the difference between the first and second period for you guys?
Just getting pucks out of our zone, handling pucks and making plays. I thought the first period we were kind of just shooting pucks around the boards and kind of causing our own problems. I think second period we took better care of the puck and showed on the scoreboard.
Thank you, Drake.
Thank you.
John.
Actually, the correct answer to the last question to Drake was, it was me. I was the difference. I made it 2-0.
He's not like that, John.
Steve Levy, he's a
humble
team player.
Unlike Levy, he's humble.
There's no I in Levy.
And as usual, the parting shot from Barry Melrose. Joined by a couple of true friends, here's Sean Richland, won 2 national championships, a player in Michigan. Dave Starman's a pro scout for the Montreal Canadiens, and we're enjoying what we're seeing after 40 minutes of play tonight in Tampa. And despite the score, Dave, there was a really good push there by Denver, even though they haven't scored on the scoreboard, something they could take with them into the third.
You know, one thing Jim Montgomery has always talked about during the course of the season was, if the power play doesn't score, make sure you get momentum out of it. Get chances out of it. 4 or 5 good chances. Get the heart rate up. Make some things happen. And we've talked about that third circle, the circle between the two circles in the offensive zone, and Montgomery wanted to get pucks and people there. And I think in the last 5 minutes on the power play, Denver has gotten a lot of opportunity to get just that, pucks and people, Sean, to the front of the net.
In North Dakota on the other side, we're doing a good job of blocking shots. As you see Pullman diving to go in and block the shot, not letting that shot get through on the man advantage. But Denver had some energy here at the end of the period, but a period predominantly dominated by North Dakota, and they did a great job, North Dakota, of having energy from the start of this period throughout maybe the last 5 minutes, Steve. And the best part about that period for me for North Dakota was their star player was their best player in that period.
Hey, we got enough goalies on the ice? I mean, what do you want to do? How about a penalty? That's a great idea. We were talking about it off camera there. You see all those shot blocks. You want more scoring back in the college game and the pro game. Let's get some of those shots on goal.
It's an interesting topic. It's been debated endlessly on what's the best thing to do. But, you know, having as a forward, I hated it when defensemen went to the ice and blocked a shot. But will that be something that defensemen will fight for so they can continue to block shots? I'm not sure. But here's a look at some of the block shots that came in. You see leaving the feet. Again, we used to play Michigan State at Michigan a lot, and they blocked a lot of shots by going down to the ice. And it continues to be a question of, you know, if we want more scoring in hockey, should we let defensemen leave their feet to block a shot?
And my answer to that would be no. You know who used to bring that up a lot in the convention in Naples, this rule? Tim Whitehead. He used to be the former head coach of the University of Maine, now at Kimball Union. Timmy Whitehead always used to bring up, hey, should we eliminate guys from leaving their feet to block shots? Now, where you get into some minutiae there, let's say a guy leaves his feet to try to block a pass. Does that count as trying to block? Yeah. There's a lot of things that go into this, but I think that we could get some serious discussion on making sure guys stay on their feet.
Oh, just what the on-ice officials want, more gray area.
That's right.
Right? Speaking of which, we'll dive into some of the zebra action from earlier tonight. Offside or onside, Quinnipiac is going to the championship game.
Why do some cashback cards keep throwing obstacles at you? First, they limit where you earn bonus cashback. Then, those places change every few months. I think I'll pass. Quicksilver from Capital One puts nothing in your way. You simply earn unlimited 1.5% cashback on every purchase everywhere. You can't dodge the question. What's in your wallet?
Earlier tonight, in the early game of the Frozen Four, it was top-ranked Quinnipiac taking on Boston College. We pick it up. We're scoreless in the first. Quinnipiac moves it back to BC, and Boston College turns it over. That leaves to a Kevin McKernan goal. Starman, we want to clean something up here.
We do. There was some discussion as to why this player was not offside, because Quinnipiac hadn't cleared the zone when the puck was put on goal. Here, you can see it right here. Thank you, TJ Likens, for pointing out. Rule 86.2, if the puck is shot in on goal during delayed offside, the play is allowed to continue under the normal clearing zone rules. So that is a legal goal. All good. Referees made the right call.
But if it would have gone in, they would have waved off.
If it would have gone in, it's no goal. But if it touches the goalie, you can clear the zone.
Quinnipiac got a second goal and a 2-0 lead. Andrew Taviner from Travis St. Dennis. What a pass.
Yeah, great one-timer, too. He got that puck shot as soon as it hit his stick. Demko didn't really have a chance on that. The second period, BC rebounded well, but then Quinnipiac responded on the man advantage, and I felt that was a real tough goal for BC to overcome after Quinnipiac got the third one. And, you know, Thatcher Demko, the great goaltender for BC, nothing much he could do on that one for the Eagles.
Then in the third period, a one-goal game, empty net, final shot is deflected. Michael Gartigue was unbelievable. His best minute of the game was the last minute of the game.
Yeah, he really came through at the end of the game.
He looked like Mario Gosselin there, didn't he? Little ole.
And Quinnipiac able to hang on and win by a score of 3-2. The Bobcats trying to become the third ECAC team to win the national championship in the last four seasons. They advanced to the championship game for the second time. They lost to Yale in the title game in 2013. Quinnipiac can relax and wait for their opponent. Third period's on the way.
Hot pizza. It's a beautiful thing. Introducing the 2016 Domino's DXP with a built-in warming oven. Learn more about this first-of-its-kind vehicle at dominosdxp.com.
These outdoor furnishings from Lowe's are so stylish, it almost feels like we're inside the house. Not that I've been in there. Or have I?
Now get this Garden Treasure Severson Patio Collection for only $2.48 at Lowe's.
T-Mobile does data differently. While the other guys gouge you for every bit of data you use, now T-Mobile lets you stream all the video and music that you want from your favorite services free without using one bit of your LTE data. Plus, you can roll your unused data forward. Nobody does data like T-Mobile. Get four lines with 10 gigs of 4G LTE data each for just $35 per line from T-Mobile.
Two-thirds of our planet is covered in it. So why do nearly 800 million people suffer from lack of clean water around the world? That's completely unacceptable to me. And that is why I'm working on a way to solve this global problem. Like here in Sao Paulo, Brazil. By taking the polluted water we already have and providing technologies to filter it back into clean water. My name is Manny, Senior VP of Technology. We are Coke.
We're back in Tampa. Oh. It's just a cool setting. It's a cool American city. Welcome back to the 2016 NCAA Frozen Four presented by Northwestern Mutual. We're inside that arena where North Dakota is 20 minutes away from reaching the national championship game against Quinnipiac. The last shutout in a Frozen Four was the 2013 title game when Jeff Malcolm shut out the Quinnipiac Bobcats. Sean Hunwick also had one in 2011 for Michigan. Barry, it's hard to imagine Denver's going to be able to get two goals in this third period, the way things have gone so far.
Well, if they don't get the two goals, the question is, what happened to the Pac rim line? It was supposed to be one of the best lines in the nation. It was supposed to be instant offense. And early in the game, it looked like you're going to have some chances. Heinen's flying through the neutral zone. Lots of room to make a pass. You've got Gambrell going up the right side. Good chance for a little dump and chase right there. Puck goes to Gambrell. He goes in. Nice wrist shot. Doesn't score on it, but a nice opportunity. In the second period, where did those things go? They went bye-bye. There ain't no room. There ain't no time. There ain't no space. You see Kajula right there, and he talked about hiding behind some people. He just quietly comes in from the bench. You got four people on that side of the rink. Catches Denver by surprise. They think the puck is going to go up the wall pretty easily. And you're going to see it turned over
little bit of a lazy pass right there. Goes in for Julius Dick. He walks in there, and that wicked wrist shot we've been talking about. So the pack rim line for Denver better get going, because the Kajula line for North Dakota is flying.
He's been great in his career against Denver. North Dakota hasn't lost a game when leading after two. Denver hasn't won a game when trailing after two. Here comes Moore right off the faceoff, but poked away nicely by Ledoux. Pack rim line out there to start the third. Jim Montgomery saying, let's go, boys. If we're going to do this, we're going to need you. Get out there. Heinen tried to go back to Moore. He had him open, but broken up by North Dakota. Moore had the pizza to Kajula. Now he's going to try to make up for it, but that shot is just wide off the pass from Gambrell. Heinen, Moore on the doorstep, but Johnson is there. So a good shift from the big line. Quint Kesnick between the benches.
Jim Montgomery saying to his team as they were leaving their locker room, someone has to land the first punch for us. We've got time, but this is a heavyweight tilt, and someone's got to land that first punch. Meanwhile, North Dakota, I do not see Luke Johnson on their bench. He skated off after a knee-to-knee collision with a teammate, 11 goals, 10 assists. Junior from Grand Forks, looks like they'll skate a man down for the majority of this third period.
Yeah, that's one extra man, one man off the bench.
But you know, right now, this might be their last game of the year. They're not worried about saving anybody.
Yep.
You got a day off until Saturday when the final game is, so you'd have plenty of time to rest the guys. So I don't think Jimmy Montgomery cares if he double shifts or even triple shifts guys. Whoever has a chance of making a turning point in this game and get things going, he's going to play him.
Johnson is a good faceoff guy, though, so if the game becomes tight, they'll miss him there.
Yep.
That heavy line with Pagansky and Gardner. But
it's not as heavy now.
Not as heavy. Saw Colton Sanderson move up, and he's had a good game moving up in that slot. So now the big line.
Well, he's 200 pounds, so it's still pretty heavy then.
Exactly. Senior, Moose Jaw.
Still a little chunky.
Everyone from Moose Jaw is tough, right?
Yeah, they are. Moose Jaw. You come from Moose Jaw, you got to be tough. There's so many jokes about Moose Jaw.
Adam Plant throws it in. Denver get off to a good start. The third period here in Tampa. Icing? Yes. Besser was trying to get in front of Plant, but couldn't do it. And the faceoff back down to me. North Dakota end. Coverage of the NCAA Championships continues with the Bowling National Championship, April 16th, 6:30, ESPNU. For more information on the NCAA Bowling Championship, visit NCAA.com, your home for all 90 NCAA Championships. Gambrell faceoff, won by Kajula. Comes around.
It's a one-man wrecking crew tonight, Johnny.
Doing it all. Travis St. Dennis was such a big factor, not scoring in the first game. He had two assists. Kajula's doing it with scoring, and there on the faceoff win.
You know what we got? There's a lot of scouts in the building here tonight, NHL scouts.
Yeah, the Oilers, Craig McTavish.
Kajula's got to be one of the guys they're looking at.
Yeah.
You know, you can find a lot of reasons why he can't play, but the bottom line is he's out there here with a lot of first-round picks, and he's the best player on the ice by a mile. So a guy like that deserves a shot with somebody.
Yeah, when you're 5'10", 180, you've got to be really good to
really,
play in the NHL. Really good. But like you said, he'll have a pro career of some
place. Yep. He'll make a good dollar somewhere.
Matt Marcino's had a good night in the faceoff, though, but he gets thrown out. Lucas Savage has come in there. Lucas Savage can't win it. It's won by North Dakota. Good job by Johnny Simonson, but the puck goes out of play, and they'll do it again from the same dot. So now Marcino can go back in there and try to win one. He's, like I said, he's been really good, 6 of 7 on the dot. But now Jim Montgomery will make a line change as Marcino's still chirping at the line. Want to know why he was booted.
Simonson says, I'll take the draw.
Yes, that's right. All right, set play off the draw. New line out, let's go. There you go. Hellman throws at the net. The last part wasn't quite executed. The first part was. Face-off win, tip it back to D, but then it was from there nothing.
200-foot game, you hear it all the time, but that's what you're trying to do. No turnovers in the neutral zone. If you're going to get a chance, you got to go 200 feet through all those layers that we have. So that'll be something to watch for the rest of this game by North Dakota.
Cam Johnson looks very smooth and calm and comfortable in this game so far. The new North Dakota netminder. Kajula can't get it out. We'll try again. And they do. He's skating here on the line, on the fourth line. Throw him out there more often.
The way he's playing, you're exactly right.
He's out there with Trevor Olsen and Shane Gersich. Terry takes down Kajula. Again, Barry, arms raised in a V, wants a penalty. Didn't get it. Keeping the pressure on the D. He's on the bench again, looming large. That green tie can be seen from St. Petersburg.
It's like Jeter's roof in Davis Island. You can see it from space.
Barry's neighbor here, Florida. Same square footage.
Same square footage.
Oh, his garage is the same square footage.
Biggest house in Florida, Derek Jeter.
What's his air conditioning bill?
If you have to ask, you can't afford it.
Yeah, true. Another icy. This is Trey Kojolik. And we've seen some neutral zone collisions, Barry. A lot of times they look accidental, but this is the play. Oh, I see Terry.
He spun around. Yeah, he lost the puck.
Took down Kojolik.
Anytime you can take Kojolik down this game, that's a good move.
Still, that's a trip to trip.
It was, yeah.
He didn't hit the puck.
You could make a case that he didn't know where he was and he was just spinning around out of control.
Yeah. Kojolik changes, and here comes Denton. Moore. Down the wall, but taken by two North Dakota players. They are playing a great defensive game as North Dakota. They can suffocate you. It's going to be icing. So multiple icings now by North Dakota. Got to be careful.
We've had like six icings so far in this game. So, you know, neither team is... The reason Denver can't is because the swarming defense is by North Dakota. And the reason North Dakota's not getting through the neutral zone is they're making sure that they always have guys back. So it's basically a one-on-two or two-on-three all the time.
See Brad Berry again working the refs hard.
He wants that 20 man in the ice, Johnny. I don't think he's going to get it in the third period.
He wants his power play numbers even up a little bit in this third period.
Maybe they'll give him one against Quinnipiac. I don't think he's getting one tonight.
Marcin, let's see if his faceoff prowess continues here for Denver. He's had a good night, number 23, going against Sanderson. 50-51. Score! Will Butcher makes it a one-goal game. The acumen of Marcin on the dot pays off. Jim Montgomery knows he is a hot man on the dot. He wins the faceoff, and Butcher finishes.
Well, we're talking about the plays that Jimmy Montgomery has off the draw.
Every
line is a different play, and right here is just a draw off to the man on the side there, forehand. Throws it back to Butcher, and I've talked about Butcher's shot all game long.
Grant Arnold
with
the seal.
Just a great job. Arnold seals off, makes sure his man can't get to the point. Arnold's attacking the net in case there's a juicy rebound. Great play off a draw. Everybody in Denver knew that was going to happen. Arnold makes a play and then wins the battle. So just a great job by Denver. They've been talking about their draws, how good they are, and right there they're rewarded with a goal.
Let's see how that energizes the Pioneers. What a play by Grant Arnold. He tipped that back to Butcher, then sealed off the man, giving Butcher a lane. And watch these mitts from Arnold, Barry. Kind of looks like it hit the heel of the stick, but it goes right to Butcher. What a play.
Well, it's a set play. Everyone knows their job in that. Arnold's job is to get it back to Butcher and then make sure the man that's beside him doesn't get out to Butcher, but not take an interference penalty by doing so. And then obviously the job of the centerman in that play, Marcino, is not to lose the draw clean. Make sure it's a tie so that we can set up the play and get the shot, which happened, and they got a goal for it.
Grant Arnold has been a leader in every sense of the word, not only his presence, his personality, but also you saw him the other day. I go, Grant, you look skinny. You lose weight? He goes, yeah, 18 pounds. So he's showing the commitment in the weight room. Jim Montgomery doesn't worry about that. So when the guy who talks the most does the most, he can become a good leader.
And the beard's fantastic. You got to give Sykes some credit on the beard right there. You can just see it exploding through the helmet. The guy's a great guy. I love being around kids. I love being around the college kids, the enthusiasm they have. This guy's got a smile on his face. Is he going to play in the NHL and make a living through hockey? I'm not sure about that, but he's going to be a success whatever he does.
He'll be a coach.
Just by the way, he could be a coach.
Yeah. Turns 25 in May, so he certainly has the attention of the youngsters at Denver. So here come the Pioneers. Now, how will North Dakota respond? We saw multiple icings that finally hurt them. And the game is now 2-1. Broken stick. Back the other way. Here comes Besser. Shot blocked by Plant. Besser has it back. Try to kick it to himself. Couldn't. Out of trouble, but back to Besser. Throws it across the ice, but it skips over the stick and out of the zone.
Nice play by Besser. That's exactly where it had to go. The guy was wide open. Puck skipped over his stick and had to get a change.
Osmus, it's going to be icing again. My goodness, it's going to be about the fifth or sixth icing this period on North Dakota. Like we said the last time, we'll see if Marcin goes out there again, Barry, or if he's going to stick with the...
A team like Quinnipiac, I don't think a team like Quinnipiac cares if there's a lot of whistles. They're so structured and they're so good on draws. But a team that's skilled like North Dakota, I think they like the flow. I think they like a little bit more wide open game where Kojulia has more ice time to make plays happen. Some of those other guys that they have also. So we haven't heard Malts' name. this period. You know, Besser's hardly been mentioned, so those three guys have to have the puck on their stick.
Danton Heinen will try to win this draw against Rhett Gardner. They do. Similar play. Tip back to the point. Butcher again. Slap shot. Never got through. Block shot again by guess who? Tucker Pullman.
That's a set play off the draw. The Sensen gets it. They know the traffic lanes will be blocked, the shooting lanes. Just dish it off to the right-handed shot on the far side for the one-timer.
Good play by Stetcher. The rim around comes all the way to Pagansky. And the other side goes wide on Butcher. Behind that, throws in front, but tipped in front of by Zajac. Good pair of hands by Zajac. He's held from behind. And Denver gets it out. Heinen pearls away like he does. Gets the Butcher. Leaves it for Heinen. And he's the point guard. Beautiful play. Avoiding. Throwing over to Zajac. Gambrell has it. He'll just get it deep. Moore goes after it. Ledoux. He's there first. Good breakout, North Dakota. Here they come. Up 2-1. National championship game on the line. Quinnipiac awaits. Chizik in deep. But Blake Hillman takes it. Nice play. Clean breakout for Denver. Arnold back out there. Gets it in deep. He'll go after. There's Marcinou. In on Johnston. Chops at the goalie. A nice play by Cam Johnson. Denver pressure. Keeps it in. Behind the net, shot in front, doesn't get there. Hospice gets it out of trouble. Arnold just avoids the slash or hook. That's going to be another icing on North Dakota.
Good strength by Arsenal right there, winning that battle, man. It could have been a damaging puck right in front of the net like that. He got it, got his feet moving, dumped it out. He iced it, yeah, but it doesn't matter. He was out of trouble with no damage done. So he's had a strong game. We saw that clip of tape where he blocked three shots in a row, giving up his body. That's what leadership does.
Quentin Shore now will try to win the faceoff. Denver's out shooting North Dakota, 14-13. Saved by Johnson, the shot from Jansen. Butcher sends it in deep. Gage Osmus goes to Paul Ledoux. Ledoux back to Osmus. North Dakota can manage that puck better. Get some sustained pressure. Terry, off the skate, had a chance to get Shore. As Ledoux goes back and get it. Paul Ledoux brings it out himself, across the red line. Goes around Shore, still with it. Takes it deep with Zajac. Whacked out of there. Pioneers get it back, Shore. Zajac, plant. Gets it out. Keaton Thompson, there's Hayden Shaw, the freshman. Played his USHL hockey in Dubuque. Back to Shaw, looking, wrist shot towards the net, doesn't get there. Taken by Zajac, who gets it to Heinen. Heinen, Moore, plant the defenseman. Chips it towards the net, goes behind the net. Besser's back out there. And Schmaltz changes. Pioneers now starting to carry the play here in the third period. Johnson will hold, so we'll have yet another faceoff in the North Dakota zone. No shots on goal for North Dakota in the first 6:28 of the third period. They're hanging on.
The NCAA Frozen Four is presented by Northwestern Mutual. We help you live life differently. And in part by Fridays. In here, it's always Friday.
Welcome back. 2016 NCAA Frozen Four. Jim Montgomery's Denver Pioneers down 2-0 after two. They've made it a one-goal lead. Quint Kestick is between the benches.
Yeah, one of the biggest keys for Denver this year has been plays off of faceoffs, especially in the zone. All have names. With this skill line, the play will involve two passes. Let's see what Coach Montgomery drew up during that break here and see if they can execute.
On the first move, win that faceoff to Butcher, who has a chance to shoot it, or he can throw it over to Zajac on the other point, open for the one-timer. Heinen will try to win this on his backhand. See, Butcher has crept in, top of the circle. Heinen's got a great pair of hands. Faceoff one there.
There are draws where the centerman shoots it ahead and jumps around the centerman to get that. That was almost a play like that.
Gardner over to Pagansky, behind the net. Denver Pioneers are dominating this game. North Dakota doesn't have a shot on goal in 9 minutes going back to the second period. Moore finds Butcher, the defenseman, who's starting to take over this game a little bit. throws it across. He has Zajac open. Pagansky chips it out. Here he comes. He's got room to skate. Heinen is back checking. Oh, nice job by Butcher to get back and break up that pass, but the puck remains in the Denver end. Gambrell. Butcher will chip it high off the glass. North Dakota took that 1-0 lead. It was their first lead in a Frozen Four since 2007.
Wow. For a team that good, it's hard to believe.
Yeah, one reason why they haven't won a national title.
They're always playing from behind.
Playing from behind. Now they're playing ahead, up 2-0, but not a great third period. Will Butcher, offensive defenseman, but the speed and skating, Barry, to get back.
Well, I told you guys at the start of the game, he was in my impact player, and you see why. But 150-foot race right there, he catches the man, he takes the inside position, he intercepts the pass, and he gets it out of trouble. Plus, he's running the offense at the other end of the ring. So you can see why the guy plays tons of minutes, and he's one of the best defensemen in college hockey. And what a name, Butcher. That's a great hockey name.
Matt Marcinoux has been great on the dots. Can he win another faceoff? Marcinoux, no. Doesn't get that one. Good job by Schmaltz to win that draw, get it out of trouble. Besser, Schmaltz, and Kajula are out there against the fourth line of Denver. Grant Arnold gets it up. Lucas Savages. Lucas Savages to go down. No penalty call. Throws it in front. Arnold. Backhand. Another one. And Cam Johnson has been done a good job where there's chaos in front of him. And pucks are in that blue paint, Barry. He's ate them all up so far.
Well, Denver's out playing North Dakota right now. You mentioned the shot disparity in the third period. North Dakota's not getting any offensive zone time. They're not getting any rubber at the net. They're being outshot right now by Denver. They're being outworked by Denver. They're being outhit by Denver right now. And just like in the second period, when Denver had to answer North Dakota's run, North Dakota's got to answer Denver's run now and take control of this game again.
Gambrell, that time. Good job by Rhett Gardner. The freshman has won some faceoffs. Butcher. Play has been in the North Dakota end the entire third period. Denver needs to score again to tie the game. 2-1. Our first game was 2-1 at one point. Quinnipiac got the 3-1 goal. Boston College was able to make it 3-2 before Quinnipiac finished them off. Pagansky walks in. Puck loose in front. Squirts to the side. Ledoux, the defenseman. Watched by Zajac. Ledoux throws it to the net. Kick save. Rebound. Shot over the net. Of Gillette.
There's a penalty coming up.
Delayed penalty. North Dakota's going to get that power play. Brad Berry's been working on for a while. Kajula. Here's Besser now. Besser loses control. And North Dakota will get the power play. High sticking is the call from our Hockey East officiating crew.
Well, just what the doctor ordered for North Dakota. They've been flat. Nothing's going your way. You've got an awesome power play, and you've just been rewarded that power play. So this is a chance for North Dakota to establish their strength again, their way of playing, and take control of the momentum of this game.
Danton Heinen's stick came up right here, trying to lift the stick.
That's a no-brainer.
Easy call.
Puck hits you in the face, you're going to get a penalty.
Right to the jaw of Rhett Gardner. It got under his cage a bit.
Lucky there wasn't a cut, or it could have been even worse.
So North Dakota's been dominated. They need a shot on goal. They have a chance to make it 3-1. Quinnipiac did a similar thing in the first game. Puck bounces up. Here comes Gabe Levin. Gabe dumps his whole change. Two fresh penalty killers coming out for Denver. It's North Dakota being outshot 18-15, but they lead 2-1. Kajula. Here comes Kajula looking for a hat trick. Throws it across. Comes outside the zone. Offside. Face off outside the North Dakota zone.
Momentum's so funny. When you have it, you think you're going to have it the whole game. You're flying. You don't think. You just attack. You react to what other team's doing. North Dakota's lost their emotion and their momentum, and now they're a step behind everything. They're a step behind with the puck. They're a step behind without the puck. They had to get that back, or they're going to be just battling for 10 minutes and 50 seconds.
Clever Pullman's had a strong game blocking shots. Now he'll try to provide some offense on the power play. Kajula. Pass attempt is blocked. Schmaltz pursues the puck. Can't get there. Here comes Arnold shorthanded. Grant Arnold throws it back. Nice play. Good veteran move. Throw it back to one of your speedy, skillful defensemen. Kill some more time. Less than a minute to go on the power play. Back to get it is Ledoux. Jansen causes a turnover, but North Dakota gets it right back. Colton Sanderson gets it deep. Butcher tries to get it out, and they will. It rides the top of the boards.
That went way up there. That went over the clock.
Official had the whistle to his mouth.
That was in the sun almost.
Just in case it hit a North Dakota player, but it
put the glasses down.
Almost offside, just onside. Here comes Denver now, shorthanded. Down a goal. Adam Plant throws it across to Shore. Kicks it to himself outside the zone, but continues to kill time here. Another ineffective. Oh, almost a chance for Moore to walk in, but he was offside anyway.
Wow, this has been an ugly power play by North Dakota. Wow. Nothing's going. They look slow. They look sloppy. Basically, you can't have a power play playing defense on the power play, and that's sort of exactly what they're thinking right now. They're trying to win this game 2-1. You can see exactly what they're trying to do, and that never works.
Power play has just 10 seconds left, and then Danton Heinen will step out, and he'll be an offensive threat when he steps out of that box. Gabe Levin will take the faceoff, but it's won there nicely by Johnny Simonson. Grand Forks, North Dakota. Good. Hometown kid. Blake Hillman. Good breakout by Denver. Kent Heinen's back on the ice. You see him there, number 20. In front. Goal! We're tied. It goes off of Gage Ausmus off the centering pass, and Denver has tied the game in the third period. Matt Vornis is going to get the goal. 5'7 junior. And Voris threw in front, Barry, and it went off of Ausmus.
A prevent defense prevents you from winning. It does it in football. It does it in hockey. You just can't sit back there and try and not give up a goal and win a game. And that's exactly what North Dakota tried to do. Now they get an unlucky bounce off Ausmus' stick right here. The guy was blocking shots all night long. Bad break, but again, they weren't working. They were just sitting back, and you can't do that. Denver just had free reign to attack. And when North Dakota had that terrible power play, that just gave the Denver team more strength and more commitment, and they've taken over the game now, and we got a tie game. We got a 9-minute hockey game right now.
So strange. Van Voris, the junior, with his third goal of the year, has tied this game. See if North Dakota can get things going here. They have really struggled here in the third period. All those icings in the beginning of the period resulted in that one goal, and this kind of took the momentum away. The rink was all empty of energy.
They came out trying to win 2-0. We'll just play great defense. We don't have to take any chances. Nobody told Denver about that plan. They came out and worked their butts off.
And we'll see if the big line here get things going. Besser and Schmaltz and Kajula. Besser's in there, but now taken by Denver. Throws it across. Here they come. 2-on-1. Gambrell and Moore. Moore. Shot. Doesn't quite get to Johnson and steered away. Denver with another golden chance. Butcher in front. Deflected. Saved by Johnson. Stetcher has it. Butcher to the net. Heinen. Blocked in front. Hard wrist shot. Blocked by number 16, Besser. And he goes down. He was about to change anyway. And he's a little bit of pain as he goes to the bench. Moore again tries to split the D, but taken there by Poganski. That's offside. Levin and Hillman will get the assist on the Matt Van Voris goal. Throw it towards the net. Sometimes good things happen. We're tied late third.
Sure, TV has evolved over the years. It's gotten squarer, brighter, bigger. It's gotten thinner, even curvier. But what's next? For all binge watchers, movie geeks, sports freaks, X1 from Xfinity will change the way you experience TV.
Starts here.
John Butchergoss, Barry Melrose back in Tampa. 2-0 was the score as Drake Kajula had 2 second period goals. That man right there
Yeah, the second period, North Dakota took over. They looked faster. They looked hungrier. Great pass there by Besser right into Kajula. He goes in and scores a beautiful goal. Steals the puck in the sidewall right there. Comes in, nice wrist shot. Everything's going their way. Now we saw the draw. Great shot from the point right there by Butcher. Puck ends up in the net. And right here, Asmus, the goaltender, or the defenseman, number 20, goes off his stick. He played such a solid game. But again, they're just playing kitty by the door, just trying to win 2-1. And the puck ends up hopping into the net. Now we got a 2-2 game. And Denver's got all the momentum.
Quinn Kesnick between the benches.
Brad Berry, North Dakota. We have to get after it. Everyone together. We've worked too hard for this. You get the sense that some recent history starting to enter the minds of some of these skaters.
Fair point. They definitely have played tight in this third period. There's no doubt about it.
Yeah, they've
got to let it fly.
The guys on North Dakota have seen a lot of leads slip out of their fingers. No doubt about that.
The Johnson injury is a concern. 11 goals scored during the year, and they'll miss him. Doesn't quite make them as deep and changes the line combinations up a bit.
But it doesn't change how hard you play.
Nope. Kick save by Gillette. And now it's Denver's turn to ice the puck. For good hard wrist shot by Bryn Chizik there. Had a lot on that wrist shot, but the right pillow of Gillette. So again, this is a long-standing rivalry, 276th meeting, seventh time in the tournament. Denver has done well of late. Second time in the Frozen Four they met. One of their title games was clinched and won by beating North Dakota. They were down 2-0 here. Little hope seemed to be on the horizon, but they have owned the third period and they have tied things up. The national championship game on the line. Here's Kajula. North Dakota fans would love to put hat trick out of him. Besser.
Didn't you say earlier in the game no team has ever given up a two-goal lead and lost a game like this?
I'm not sure if I said that. Besser saved by Gillette. Well, certainly North Dakota hasn't blown a third period lead this year, and Denver hasn't come back when down after two. Osmus, he'd like to make up for his bad luck. Throws it at the net like they did to him, but Gillette gloves it.
That's a good shot. I know people think it's crazy to throw it at the net right there, but that's a tough play for the goaltender. He's got to look at me and men in front of him. He knows if he drops a puck, there's a good chance someone will just shoot it in the wide open net. So that's a pressure on him to control it clean. So those shots from the side are tough pucks to handle for a goaltender.
18,037. Nice crowd here in Tampa.
Awesome crowd.
Doubleheader Thursday on ESPN2. The title game is also here on ESPN2 Saturday night.
You notice how happy people look when they come in out of the sun?
Oh,
just charged.
Vitamin D. Need it.
North Dakota needs some vitamin D, John.
They do. They need some vitamin O. They need another goal now. But Denver has owned the third period. Here they come again. Marcin and Arnold goes offside. 6:43 left in the third period. Grant Arnold off that face-off play. Got things going. Got Denver on the board. And that clearly energized them for even the second one. And they are out shooting North Dakota 21-18 in this game.
Yeah, it started off a draw, something that we've talked about all game long that Denver's very good at, something they take pride at, something they work at, and it ended up turning this game around for Denver. So
Simonson sees it for Gerstich. Goes wide. North Dakota needs some pressure, needs some shots. Here they go. Maybe they'll get it now. Off the end boards in front. Levin is there. Throws it up. Kept in. No. Thought that was on the line.
There's a penalty too, John. To North Dakota, elbow penalty to North Dakota.
All right, away from the play. Good pickup, Barry. And to the penalty box goes Trevor Olsen, the sophomore from Duluth, Minnesota. The people's elbow, left side of your screen. Oh, keep an eye on number 11.
You can't do that this time in the game.
Oh, my, yes.
Wow.
That was the people's elbow.
Boy, that could almost be a five.
See, they're not going to look at it. You can see Jim Montgomery. He wants them to look at it. He wanted to look at the other hit from behind earlier in the game. And, you know, there's nothing wrong with looking at it. That's what his point probably is. Just look at it. If the guy's innocent, he's innocent. But
it looked like a bad hit. It looked like the elbow was up. And there was.
I didn't know if it grazed the shoulder.
That's what I mean. I'd like to see if he did hit the head.
I thought he might have got the shoulder first.
Well, but they are looking at it.
Yeah. Obviously a big size difference. 6'2", Trevor Olsen, and 5'8", Gabe Levin. But you have to be aware of that when you go for it.
And you can't do that now.
And it didn't really need to do
no,
it.
No, there's 6.5 minutes left. You don't need to send a message in the third period.
The fourth liner trying to get his team going because they are flat. And without question, they're just flat right now, and they need something. Just try to do it. Let's see if he gets the shoulder first. No, I don't know. Five here.
It looked like he threw the elbow to me. And nobody...
I like how...
wants to give... You know, keep the game as physical as I do, but you just can't do that in college hockey.
I do like how Gabe Levin didn't go down and kind of pretend he was injured. We see a lot of players do that, and good luck charms abound for this North Dakota. See, that was tough. You know, Levin did go down late after he kind of chipped the puck. He was obviously trying to protect himself. He's a little guy, and that sums up North Dakota Nation right now.
Oh, does that ever? That's like a picture.
What has happened? We had this game.
In the dictionary, close to a North Dakota fan, a picture of that lady right there.
And now Brad is thinking about Jim Montgomery, the face he had. Like, what can I do to help? What's the move to make here? What's the thing I can do to help my team get out of this funk?
Well, first off, I got to pray that it's not a 5-minute major.
That's right. Otherwise,
so let's get out of that thing first.
Because the rest of regulation would they'll be shorthanded just about. We'll take it to 125.
Let's get it to a 2-minute minor. We kill it off, get our penalty killing going. And
there's Jim Montgomery once again.
There's those draws. He's drawing off draws again. So.
And he was a great player at Maine, obviously. Most outstanding player.
All right, maybe we can see it better right here.
This could be the best camera we have right here. Elbows tucked at this moment. He definitely extends it a bit. Gabe Levin got right up. He appears to be fine. A lot of players would kind of stay down and maybe sell it a little bit more, which maybe would help get the five.
They called it an elbowing. It certainly could have been interference. You could either go with either one of those.
And obviously it's now in their minds because they've looked at it long.
And obviously it's not an easy decision.
No, because the game's on the line too.
And they've been looking at it for a while.
And the player's fine.
They don't want to call a 5-minute major.
Right. But obviously they're instructed. And let's see.
No, if they have to, they have to, but they don't want to.
This tells me it's a five if he's explaining to Brad Berry. All right, so it's going to stay a minor. You wonder why it would need an explanation, but our officials for this game, you mentioned.
Is Jimmy buying it?
Hockey East crew.
I don't know if Jimmy's buying it.
Jamie Kulharski.
He bought it.
Jamie Kulharski, Cameron Voss thought about it, and they're going to keep it at two. Heinen now.
It was a borderline two.
But it's still a power play, and Denver can still take the lead. Their power play tonight is 0 for 3. Five shots. Can they take the lead? More. Four forwards and Butcher. Pagansky clears. Two two in the third. The winner plays Quinnipiac in the national championship game. Sloppy start to Denver's power play, but here they come now. They'll enter the zone with time and space. Heinen towards the net, doesn't get there.
He took too long. He's looking for the perfect shot.
Stetcher, aggressive player. He can do something special. Not afraid of the moment. Throws it down. Kajula sniffing on Butcher. Pressuring. The Butcher skates away. Beautiful skater to Gambrell. Marcinou, cross ice stump. He does that because he saw Moore over there. He can get quickly on Kajula. Steals it. One-timer helmet over the cage. That was a rocket. And cleared nicely by Schmaltz. Power play more than halfway over. Here comes Blake Hillman. Draft eligible freshman. Zajac will rim it around. Ooh, Marcinou's hit well before the puck gets there. That easily could have been interference. Not called there. And Gillette leaves it for once again Hillman. 5 minutes left in the third period. Overtime looming in Tampa. Roaming. Here comes Terry. He's dangerous. Dangled through, almost got a shot off, chipped in front, tried to bank it with Shore, but Johnson's able to keep his body at an angle where the puck doesn't deflect him. So Blake Hillman with a clapper from the point that rattled the glass behind Johnson.
Hillman scored a goal like this in a regional game. The guy got a rocket of a shot. He scored his second or third goal of the season in the regionals. It's unbelievable, hard to believe that he only had one goal prior to the regional tournament, but he can unload it, and you saw the velocity he shot it with there. If that thing hits the top part of the net, that thing's a goal.
24 seconds left in the Olsen penalty. Faceoff, that was dropped, and no tread again. Levin thought he won that cleanly, but
he's... Well, he's going to be a lawyer. He wants to be a lawyer.
That's right,
he thinks
yeah.
he wins
he's
everything.
Already lawyering.
Yep.
Boyer up!
He's already getting bad habits.
5'8 senior, little guy. Well, 5'8, 162, Marina Del Rey. We did a little...
Yeah, it lives in Marina Del Rey. Wow.
Yeah, we're gabbing with Gabe, his cool feature on Twitter at the, with the Denver PR staff. And we were his guests yesterday, so go check out Gabe's Twitter and see our installment. I think we went long, Barry.
I think we did go long.
We're producer's
when
nightmare.
When you're hot, you're hot.
Ask Anthony, we're a producer's nightmare. Butcher! Heinen. Butcher! Blocked. Back to Heinen. Power play. Olsen's going to come out of the box. They want him to come right to the bench. He looks over to the bench to get see what they want him to do. Here he goes. He'll sprint to the bench, try to get that fifth skater on. Ledoux.
After that penalty, he might not see the ice again.
The fifth skater is Kajula. Kajula's at the right point. So forward, Barry back on D and a three on two.
Exactly.
Here comes Denver. Will they take the lead? No, saved by Johnson. And then into the net. Arnold Johnson tried to sell it. No arms are up. No arms are up, apparently. We're going to let that little rub go.
That little bump.
You see the heavy chirping from Stetcher. Are you serious? And the official says stop. Grant Arnold crashing the net in case there was a rebound. At the last minute, just a bit of a rub by Johnson.
Introducing the new QX60 from Infiniti.
John Butchergoss, Barry Melrose back in Tampa. We are tied late third period. Faceoffs so important, Barry. The multiple icings by North Dakota finally caught up with them in the third period.
Yeah, and Denver actually uses the faceoffs as an offensive weapon. They work on it. They have plays. Right here, the puck is going to go to the man on the right side right there. It doesn't go back to Butcher. Puck ends up right there. Hillman doesn't get it deep. That's fine, but you saw what happened. Now you're going to see the goal. Same thing, lineup. Everybody's in the same position. Puck is going to go to the man on the right side. And then back to Butcher. Butcher's got that quick shot before the goaltender, Gillette, or Johnson can get set. It beats him up high. So you saw the two draws, one by Denver. One resulted in a scoring chance and the goal. The other didn't result in a scoring chance, but they still won it clean, and that's what you're trying to do on every draw.
Every faceoff now could be the difference in the game. We're late in the third period. Schmaltz gets it deep. Who will be the hero? Who will score a goal they'll remember for the rest of their lives? It's coming here on ESPN2. Good play by Stetcher. Puck comes in the air, and here comes North Dakota. Dominated in the third period, but all it takes is one. Kajula, Besser, Schmaltz are out there. But Denver's going to get it out. Terry, Gambrell, he's with Shore. Loses control. Denver's changing. That gives Schmaltz some time, but he's towards the end of his shift. He'll dump, and he'll go change. Hillman, the defenseman, gets it in deep. Moore will go get it. Moore, Heinen, and Gambrell are out there. Dangerous line. But here comes North Dakota back the other way. Pullman retreats. Gambrell trying to get it out. Can't, but Zajac will get to it first. Great job by Sanderson. Shot saved. Rebound. Oh, Gillette saving the day. Back to Pullman. Pullman trying to find a lane. Wrist shot high over the net. Lot on that. Wow, a lot on that wrist shot. So North Dakota now. Finally some pressure. Look out for Heinen. Breaking in. Shot. He was tired, and he realized the defenders were closing, so he said, at least I'll get a shot on goal. So North Dakota finally bury a couple of chances.
Yeah, exactly. They attacked a little bit. There's the turnover they created. There's the quick shot.
Rhett Gardner.
Bounce off the stick. The wide open edge. Weren't able to bring it in front by Besser right there. But this is what they haven't seen in the third period. Attack. Win some battles. Puck gets through Hillman. Lucky Sanderson. Bounce off the lucky bounce off the head of the goaltender right in Gillette. But again, they just won some battles finally. They look quick again.
Puck thrown in front. Arnold in the corner trying to win the battle and get one more chance here. North Dakota comes out with it. Chizik throws it across. Arnold's going to get it out though. Janet Tween in the fin was breaking down on the right side. There he is. Butcher. He'll be out here late in this game. A guy you can count on. Number four and a guy to make things happen. Gets it in deep. But Denver's changing. Pajula. Zajac gets it out. Shore chips it to himself. Too hard though. That's Shore slides offside as Jansen enters the zone.
North Dakota had a wild change right there too. We've been talking about Denver changes all game long. North Dakota had guys jumping for open doors and boards.
It's a head scratcher for sure here in the third period. Brad Berry sweating this one out. Looking for someone to come through. Heinen, Moore, and Gambrell. North Dakota doesn't go with the big line head to head. Sanderson's out there. Good job by Rhett Gardner. He's in a strong game. Here he is. He's out there. Just had that wrist shot chance, and he's out there again. He's won some faceoffs in this period, and there's been obviously a lot of faceoffs in North Dakota zone. Ledoux's out there with Pullman against the Pac Rim line. Ooh, hit check. Nothing called. In the corner, Heinen. Nice hit in the corner. He takes it. Gambrell tries to come out of it. Puck works its way up and out, but Pullman is there. Good position. Here's Schmaltz. Time for North Dakota's big line to provide some magic late. That's going to be icy. So North Dakota's going to get a face-off in the Denver end. We're exactly 1 minute left. Earlier today on Doubleheader Thursday, Quinnipiac defeats Boston College. They are in the national championship game again. They were in Pittsburgh in 2013. It'll either be North Dakota or Denver. Quinnipiac had never played Boston College, and they have never played either.
And obviously Quinnipiac's hoping for seven overtimes. We play into Friday morning. We miss our golf game. Game goes on forever and everyone gets beat up.
Timeout for Jim Montgomery. He wants to make sure his best players are rested here for this big faceoff. It was 2-0 after 40, Barry, but Denver has fought their way back with Butcher and Van Voorhees. The two defensemen tie the game.
Well, they did it the old-fashioned way. They earned it. They just outworked North Dakota. There's Butcher. We talked about what a great player he's been for Denver off the draw, which we've been talking about all game long. And here's just a puck thrown at the net. But, you know, the harder you work, the luckier you get. And Denver was working very hard right there. They got a bounce. Went off a defenseman's stick into the net. We got a tie game. A minute going into overtime.
Look at those records this year after two, and you can stretch it out too. In the last 3 years, Denver is one win, 24 losses, seven ties when trailing after two. But again, this time of year, records certainly don't mean as much because it's the whole different atmosphere and the pressure and the big NHL rink and the 18,000 fans and so much on the line.
And knowing it's your last game you'll ever play,
could
some
be.
Guys.
Yep. So here we go, big faceoff. And Brock Besser with an outstanding freshman year. Vancouver Canuck first round pick goes up against the senior, Gabe Levin. Freshman against senior. Besser wins it. Shot to the net, block. Besser gets it back, rebound, score! Nick Schmaltz has scored. Leads 3-2.
You're killing me, Schmaltz. What a play by Schmaltz. But again, Besser won the draw, but it wasn't a draw like Denver's goal. It was sort of like three chances, and the third one went in. North Dakota just won the battles. They won the draw, and they just attacked the net. They got a couple lucky breaks, but again, they all worked Denver there and won the battles. And let's look right off the draw. Besser gets it. It goes back. Now the first shot at the net. Doesn't get through. Battles won. Third shot at the net. Gets through. And right there, you're going to see Smoltz finally win the last puck battle and put the backhand into the net. What a play off the draw.
So Besser wins the faceoff. Then he got the shot on goal that resulted
in the third shot
for Smoltz.
Yep.
Net is empty. Denver, extra attacker. They try to tie this game. Puck goes into the stands. So once again, Besser, the freshman, wins the faceoff.
He's a right-handed shot. He wins it back.
Kajula shoots, but the shot gets blocked.
Doesn't get through. It gets blocked. And then the rebound goes
to Besser.
Oh,
just.
And right then it goes to Smoltz, and then Smoltz throws it in the wide open net. And Smoltz has had a quiet game tonight, folks. This guy's a stud player. He has not had the puck much in this game. Nice way to redeem himself for his teammates.
First round draft pick of the Chicago Blackhawks.
But again, everything happens with the draw being one. If you lose the draw, nothing happens good. If you win the draw, you have a chance of scoring, you know, a greasy, ugly goal like we just saw right there.
What a goal. Heinen tries to tie it. Gets blocked. Denver tries to tie this game with the net empty. Heinen along the boards. Push from behind. Nothing called. Gambrell goes down. Puck comes out. Now the puck's back in. Zajac has Rude. Under 30 left. Stetcher trying to clear. Kept in by Denver. Here comes Butcher. He has already scored once. Wide on purpose. Heinen behind the net. Sure. In front to Gambrell. Backhand by Butcher. Snared by Johnson. It was going wide. But he stops play with 11.8 left.
Thought North Dakota played this pretty well. Obviously, there's next man on the ice, so you're going to be outnumbered. But the puck was kept to the side. There were no breakdowns. Everyone was strong in the wall. No battles lost almost right there, though. And then right there, there's a turnover. Johnson with that quick hand froze it up. He didn't like what he saw. You don't like to freeze it if you don't have to, but right there, certainly, with the pressure Denver is putting on, get a faceoff.
Huge faceoff. With 11.8 to go, Kajula will not take it. Number 22, Rhett Gardner, has been really good this period. He's a big body, and he's going to take this all-important faceoff against Marcinou. Marcinou's also been good. I can't help think of Jordan Smoltz, Nick's brother, who was part of that devastating loss to Minnesota and Philadelphia. Yeah. I know Jordan's watching.
Yep.
I know how much he loves his brother, and I know he's just thrilled right now for his alma mater, for his team, and for his brother, as they're going to make sure the clock is right here. Every tenth of a second counts in this situation. Now Denver's snared, probably 12-8. Yeah, I think a full second should be back on the clock. Good look there by our ESPN clock and camera angle. So this should be at least 12.
Is that our buddy Ty in the penalty box there?
It ties down there.
Ties down there, yeah.
NCAA.
Boy, the big boys are down there. They're making sure everything's going good.
So they're going to 12-6. That's about that. I thought it was about a second. It ran off. It was tough to tell. The puck was snared like that.
That's an eternity. I've been on the ice for 12.6 seconds. I've been on the bench for 12.6 seconds. When you're behind or ahead, it's an eternity.
So, yeah, shocking. I mean, they're feeling great. Then they start to really press, and the game is tied.
Basically, North Dakota's had 4 good minutes of play here in the third period.
And we talked about
turned it on after that power play.
And we talked about the faceoffs, you know, all game long.
Yep.
Brad Berry again on the bench. And 12.6 seconds to go. Marcinou against Rhett Gardner, the freshman against the junior.
This is where he said 12.6 seconds on a bull named Fu Manchu.
Alberta against Saskatchewan. Gardner from Saskatchewan. It's a 50-50 draw. Stetcher takes it. He falls on the puck. Denver tries to dig it out. Down the ice it goes. North Dakota is going to the championship game. Rhett Gardner, Cam Johnson, they're already hugging. We still got 1.8 to go.
From Moose Jaw, the Moose Jaw boy.
It wasn't pretty, but they've gotten the job done.
What a great shot. A rolling puck. He shoots 40 feet in the air.
Would have been icy if it went wide.
It lands in between the blue line and the net and just crawls into the net. There's right there. Puck's down on the ice. Puck comes free, just whacks it into the air. Has no idea where it's going. Puck hits the middle of the net.
170 feet away.
170 feet of heaven, Johnny boy.
That's right.
If you're a North Dakota fan.
Finally, at long last, North Dakota returns to the championship game. But there's one more hill to climb for this long and proud program. End the drought and win the Natty. Quinnipiac is in the way.
Three different games. First period, no shots. Neither team had much going. Second period, North Dakota took over. Cajula scored two goals. Third period, Denver took over. And for basically, 18 minutes with the best team by far after they tied it up 2-2.
And they'll wear the white again on Saturday night. Quinnipiac, the number one overall seed, will be back in the navy and gold as the home team. And the final change. And North Dakota will be back in the white. For Denver, again, it was so tough for them the first two periods. They come back with grit and with smarts to tie the game, and then shockingly, they lose it in the final minute.
One of the greatest sayings I ever heard, losing hurts more than winning feels good.
It does.
It's the strongest emotion there is when you're losing a game, and they work for all year long, maybe 4 years in some states. Tough, tough loss for Denver.
Tough loss for Denver. Handshakes with these conference rivals. They see each other a lot in the NCHC.
Sixth time they played each other this year.
The sixth time is a charm for Nick Schmaltz. He scores the goal he'll never forget. Timed it perfectly. Came across the crease perfectly. That's hockey sense. And he has it. And he has brought his team to the championship game. We're not done yet. From where? Tampa. You got it. Coming back. What a finish. Nick Schmaltz is the hero. Rhett Gardner, the freshman from Moose Jaw, Saskatchewan, had an outstanding game. He gets the empty netter. The Schmaltz boys, they are the definition of chill. And Nick is with Quint.
Nick along with head coach Brad Berry. Face-off with about a minute to go in the zone. As you're setting up for that draw, what's going through your mind?
Yeah, Bubs just called a high blast play, and we're looking weak side defenseman, but obviously, we wanted a shot first, and catch kind of fanned on it. Besser made a great play, saw me back, go to the net, and fell in the open net, so a lucky bounce, but we earned our bounces tonight, I thought.
You know, this post-game handshake, I just made a comment, a little different. There's a mutual respect amongst league rivals. What's it like to be so familiar with a Denver team and now to get the ultimate victory in the Frozen Four?
Yeah, they're a great team. We battled with them all year. We were dead even on the year, and we came out on top tonight, but they're got to give credit to them. They're a great team. They battled hard, and they had a heck of a season.
Coach, 2-0 lead, and you had to like the way things were going, and then all of a sudden, the third period, the game changed. What was it like trying to, you know, get the momentum back after the score became 2-2?
Well, first of all, I thought we did a good job in the second period getting those two goals, and it was good puck management. We got away from that a little bit in the third period. But you know what? Just at one of the timeouts, just said we came out too far this year. We had to make sure that we dug in, and our guys dug in. Great players make great plays, and they made a great play.
I heard you said that. You said we've worked too hard to basically stop now.
Yeah. You know, like I said, we've talked about it all year, about trying finally to get here and checking that last box. You know what? We did. We worked so hard to get here, and again, proud of the way our guys responded after that, giving up the two goals.
What's it mean? Drake had two big goals. Nick had a goal. Your star power delivered. What does that mean?
Well, it's been like that all year. You know, we're a four-line team, and we got six defensemen, and obviously Cam Johnson's done a great job in net. But again, at this time of year, big players make big plays, and they did. They've done that time and time again this year, and we'll need it again on Saturday night.
That's right, guys. We'll see you on Saturday night.
Thank you.
One more box to check. As Jerry York, the coach of Boston College, said after their tough regional hang-on win against Duluth, he said, it's hard to win. Now that the game is over, it's a win's a win.
Well, no Cinderellas this year. I think everyone realizes the two best teams in the nation are playing off.
It's a great point.
Saturday. Quinnipiac's no weaknesses. I don't think they're quite as skilled as North Dakota when you just look at the pure skill level.
But they're fast.
They're faster. They're no fundamental weaknesses. Their special teams are better. Goaltending is probably a push. Again, you don't get to this point in the season with any weaknesses or places that you can be beaten. So I think it should be a heck of a game. I'm looking forward to watching it. I love the character the North Dakota showed tonight coming in. It would have been very easy to lose this game after blowing a 2-0 lead late in the third period. So they showed a lot of character. Quinnipiac showing a lot of character. They've been the best team all year long. I think we're in for a fantastic finish Saturday night.
A traditional power looking for yet another national championship. Yeah. Quinnipiac looking for their first. It will be an outstanding game. The two best teams in the country, the two best resumes, head-to-head on ESPN2 on Saturday. For Barry Melrose, I'm John Butchergosset, and our entire ESPN crew, we love hockey. Thanks for watching.